Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Texas Stadium. It's the home of the Dallas Cowboys, but tonight it's high school football, as it is the Final Four in the state of Texas as the Cooper Cougars take on the Lake Highlands Wildcats right here in Texas Stadium. Hello, everybody. I'm Jimmy Pogue along with Phil Ashby here on AISD Cable Channel 7. And Phil, biggest game in Cooper football history since the late 60s.
Well, it's been 1967, the last time the Cougars reached this level of the state playoffs. One more game and the state championship next week, the week before Christmas. And football in December in Abilene doesn't happen very often, and it's a golden opportunity. The Cougars don't want to let it pass by.
We start off tonight in our pregame show talking about the men that have gotten their teams here. For Cooper, let's start at the top and talk about Randy Allen. He played for Cooper. He played at SMU. He's played in this area before. Now he's come back, and he's trying to lead his ball club one more inch over the next two games to win a state title.
Well, that's kind of been the slogan for this football team in this program, one more inch, because in 1967, the legend goes they came within an inch of winning the state title against Austin Reagan. So that's kind of been something, the calling cry of this football team. Randy Allen, when he came to Cooper several years ago, he thought he could get this program to this level. He's done it with a team that started 3-3. Now they're 11-3 and playing as well as anybody in the state.
Tonight, however, for the Cougars, they're going to have to stop Lake Highlands' Devorin Hightower. Hightower, one of the class players in the state of Texas, over 2,000 yards on the ground this year as he leads the Wildcat Wishbone.
6'2", 190, a big guy that played running back before they moved him to quarterback, and he is the offense. He scored 28 touchdowns for this team, just an outstanding runner. Not only can beat you with speed on the outside, he likes to run inside the tackles and against the grain. If you can stop Hightower, you feel real good of stopping the Lake Highlands offense.
Marquee matchup also tonight, because the Cougars are going to send out one Dominique Rhodes, who has run rampant in the playoffs. In fact, this week's stat of the week, Dominique Rhodes is scoring once every 10 touches of the football.
That's just an incredible amount of touchdowns, and he has been the most dominating player in the high school playoffs in 96. No doubt about it. He's got 15 touchdowns in the playoffs alone and has raised his game a level that we have not seen in Cooper history.
One of the other things tonight is going to be a big factor in tonight's ball game, the defense. It is led up front by Roy Strahan and Kevin Stevenson. They are turning in incredible performances.
And tonight it will be stopping the wishbone offense of Lake Highlands, and it will start with stopping the fullback dive, because if you can stop the fullback drive, it really limits what the wishbone can do to you. Not many people have stopped the dive of Lake Highlands. That's a tall test. But the junior defensive tackles of Cooper have really answered every call this season. And so you got to feel good about them up front.
A lot of times games like this come down to intangibles. One of the biggest intangibles we're going to talk about during the course of the ball game tonight is the fact that the man that invented the wishbone, Emory Ballard, back at Texas with Darrell Royal, once coached at Mississippi State. His assistant at Mississippi State, one Joe Krausen, the defensive coordinator at Cooper, who better to stop the wishbone than the man that was around for its inception?
You're right, Jimmy. I talked to Joe Krausen a good deal before the team left Abilene today, and he is convinced that the wishbone is an offense that he knows as well as any offense that has played, because he coached with Emory Ballard. Ballard was his high school football coach at Breckenridge. They worked together at Mississippi State. With the creator of an offense working that way, it just, I think, opens up all kinds of knowledge. Talking to Joe Krausen is like opening up an encyclopedia. He is that knowledgeable about the game, and he knows this is a tough offense to stop if it's run well behind an outstanding quarterback, but he is so pleased with this defense. They are playing so well.
Keys to the ball game tonight, you talk about the fact Dominique Rhodes, 31 touchdowns. We've talked about the defensive line and Joe Krausen's defense stopping the wishbone. Truly, the ultimate test tonight may come down to Michael Anderson, who lit up Texas Stadium last week.
Well, Lake Highlands is familiar with the one-back offense. They've seen it like three times in this season, so they feel like they will try to stop Dominique first, and that would be the call of every defense that plays Cooper. But Michael Anderson, the last 2 weeks of the playoffs, has been around the 200-yard mark throwing the football. He's not making any mistakes. His touchdown to interception ratio is like 19-5. He hasn't thrown an interception since deep into the regular season. So he has really been making great decisions and making good throws, very safe football, and that's something the Cougars will need here again tonight.
The Cooper Cougars tonight against the Lake Highland Wildcats. Coming your way next, the state semifinals right here on AISD Cable Channel 7. Cable Channel 7, everybody, as we get ready for the coin toss. We've had the playing of the school songs. We are waiting for the national anthem, and the captains will go down on the field, and we will take you down on the field for the coin toss as we get ready for tonight's semifinal game between the Cooper Cougars and the Lake Highland Wildcats, and we go down to the middle of the field.
Abilene Cooper's business team, so they'll call the toss while it's in the air. If I drop it, we'll do it again. I'm sure you you've got instructions, but your four options are kick, receive, defend a goal, or elect to take your option in the second half. Call it while it's in the air, all right? Call it.
Tails.
He called tails, it's heads. You in the call. They want to receive the ball. What goal do you want to defend? You put your back to that goal. Lake Highlands won a toss.
Has won the toss. They have elected to receive. Cooper will defend the north goal as the sign comes up. It says on to state. And this semifinal football game is moments away from getting started. Welcome back, everybody, to Texas Stadium. I'm Jimmy Pogue, along with Phil Ashby, along with our Cable Channel 7 crew tonight. Rob Westman, our director, along with Randy Cluck and Eddie Raines. And Phil, as we get ready for this ball game, we have talked about the numbers going in. It comes down now to crunch the last few numbers. What do you think it's going to take for both sides tonight?
Well, for Cooper, it's going to take really what got them here, and that's a lot of balance on offense. And they've, if you look at their yardage throughout this season, it is almost even running and passing, and that has continued in the playoffs, particularly the last couple of weeks. Michael Anderson in the passing game has overcome really the injury to Miles Durham, and he's spreading the wealth around in the passing game, and that has opened up the game for Dominique Rhodes and the rushing attack. That's something they've got to have again here tonight, a lot of balance on offense. On defense, the Cougars have to prevent DeGorian Hightower from breaking the big run. He has done it so often this year, 28 touchdowns from this quarterback from Lake Highlands. If they can keep him somehow bottled in and breaking the long runs and keep Lake Highlands from really keeping the ball away from the Cougar offense, then they have an excellent shot of winning this game. Last week, Lake Highlands really upset John Tyler with an offensive drive that went 12, 14 plays. And that's a key.
And now we'll take it back down across the way for our national anthem. Cougars have waited since 1969 to get to this point in their season, a state semifinal. And tonight they get to that state semifinal against the Lake Highlands Wildcats. Lake Highlands comes in with a record of 13-1. Cooper is 11-3, and you're looking at maybe two of the best backs in the state of Texas, DeVorian Hightower of Lake Highlands and Dominique Rhodes for Cooper.
Well, they have been really the most dominant players in the state of Texas, particularly in the playoffs, and that's really what you want a player to do, and that is raise the level of their game in the playoffs. Both of those players have. Last week, both had big games. Dominique Rhodes two touchdowns on the ground, another with a punt return, and then DeVarian Hightower leading his team with like 187 yards rushing against John Tyler, really the prohibitive favorite in that ball game. Lake Highlands back in the semifinals for the second straight year. They lost right here on this field to Flower Mound Marcus last year in the semifinals. They fully expected to get Flower Mound Marcus again this week, but surprise, surprise, the Cooper Cougars are here, and the Cougars, I believe, are ready to play this ball game.
Back deep for Lake Highlands, number 10, Terrence Jefferson, the deep man. Also number 2, Anthony Harden, and across the way, number 8, Roshan Taylor, as we get ready for this one to start from Texas Stadium in Irving. And Roy Strahan to kick it off for the Cougars. I hope the last person out of Abilene turned out the lights, because they're all here tonight as Strahan's kickoff is away. And we are underway, and it comes down to the 6-yard line to Roshan Taylor. Taylor to the 10, 15, 20, steps out of a tackle and takes a hit at the 20-yard line, and down he goes. First and 10 from the 20-yard line. The tackle is made by Tremaine Courtney for the Cougars. And now then, DeVarian Hightower and company will start off for Lake Highland.
Good job by the special teams of the Cougars. We sometimes forget that part of the game, but just think of the punt returns, the kickoff returns, and all the coverage in these playoff games. Not very many breakdowns for the Cougars.
The wishbone for Lake Highlands. Coming out wide to the left side, number 19, Jason Eldridge on first down. DeVarian Hightower is under center. Three men in the backfield. It's the fullback, Sam Needham. And Needham gets out to about the 24, maybe the 25-yard line. A gain of 4 right up the gut. Matt Garrett had an arm on him and helped bring him down. It'll bring up 2nd and 6 after the gain of 4. Lake Highlands in the black uniforms with the silver pants. It's about their 4th different look thus far in the playoffs for the Wildcats. And now then Brent Worthy comes out wide left side on 2nd down and 6. Hightower is under center. Cooper showing a 10-man front. We will talk about that momentarily. Again, right up the middle to Needham, and Needham leans forward to about the 28-yard line. This Lake Highlands ball club has only thrown the football about 40 times through the course of their season, so don't expect to see them air anything out tonight. Hightower and Needham, the fullback, the two big guns on this team for Lake Highlands. 3rd down and 3 for Lake Highlands. They're at the 27-yard line. Wide man to the left side is Justin Smith, number 7, and Hightower will check off at the line of scrimmage. Wants to run the option, and Hightower stops shy of the first down. He stopped at the 28-yard line. May have lost the football. Cougars are up with it, and they have the ball. DeVarian Hightower lost the football, and Matt Garrett comes away with it for the Cougars, and there's a big turnover.
Right off the bat, Nathan Ford comes in, plays the quarterback, and I believe he's the man that knocked it away, and the Cougars are all over. The first break of this ball game goes in the Cougars' favor, set up inside the 30 of Lake Highlands.
1st and 10 for the Cougars from the 29-yard line of Lake Highlands. Big turn of events here early, 10:34 to go in the first quarter. Cooper will have the football from the 28-yard line of Lake Highlands. Michael Anderson, the senior, will come to the line of scrimmage, 180 pounds. Dominic Rhodes, the lone setback, number 33. And this is Dominic with a call and the carry. Off right tackle, gets to the 25. He lost the football. Flags fly at the end of the play, and Lake Highlands comes back with the ball. Dominic Rhodes has his first fumble in about the last 7 games for the Cougars, and Dominic is very slow in getting up, and he is holding that left arm very limply to his side. So another big turnaround in this ball game as Dominic Rhodes appears to be shaken up as he goes to the sideline. 1st and 10 for Lake Highlands. Both teams have fumbled now on back-to-back plays. We will check Dominique, who is having the left shoulder looked at.
In the backfield for Lake Highlands, number 9, Drew Harden.
Drew Harden, the right halfback for Lake Highlands. Terrence Jefferson, the left halfback. Sam Needham is the fullback. DeVarian Hightower, the quarterback, on first down. Flags fly. This will be a delay of game, I believe, will be the call against the Wildcats. The clock had run down to zero, and there is the delay, so a five-yard walk-off. And Dominique Rhodes, the good news, as we look down to the bench area for the Cougars, Dominique Rhodes appears to be okay right down there at about the 40-yard line.
I think Dominique is pointing to his rib cage as they tried to jerk the ball away and might have pulled something there. If that's the case, that's better than a shoulder at this point.
First and 15, Hightower comes to the line of scrimmage. Triple option offense for Lake Highlands. On first down, it's Needham, and Needham breaks one off. Gets across the 20, back to the 25, the original line of scrimmage. In on the tackle for the Cougars, number 44, Kobe Ford. It will bring up second down and 10. Lake Highlands gets to this ball game by virtue of their 21-14 win over Tyler John Tyler last week. They also defeated Waco High 27-10. They defeated Marshall 35-21. And they defeated Garland in the first round of the playoffs 8-0. Second down and 9 as Needham had 6 yards as Roy Strahan limped off the field for the Cougars. Now then, Hightower keeps. Quarterback on the option gets to the 30, maybe the 31-yard line before he is pulled down. Eric Gobert in on the stop for the Cougars. Roy Strahan appears to be okay. Cooper, meanwhile, got here by virtue of that first heart-stopping win, the last play of the game, the 57-yard draw for Dominique Rhodes. They win against Amarillo High 20-14. Then they defeat El Paso Irvin and Edmund Stansberry 42-21. They defeat Irving Nimitz by a score of 38-18. And then they defeat Flower Mound Marcus last week, 37-19. Third down and 4 for Lake Highlands. 9 minutes, 10 seconds to go, opening quarter. It's Needham, the fullback, and he doesn't have it. In fact, he is pushed back on the play. Right in the middle, Kevin Stevenson is there. And Corey Aldridge from his defensive end spot. It brings up fourth down, a punting situation for the Wildcats.
So far on the two big third down plays, the Cooper defense has been all over. The first time it was Hightower on the keeper. This time the belly dive to Needham is stopped in its tracks, and the Wildcats will have to punt it away.
Seth Hansen is back in punt formation for Lake Highlands, stands at his own 20. The rush is good, the punt is away. And fair catch is being called for, and it is made by Robbie Johnson at the Cooper 35-yard line. A 33-yard punt off the foot of Seth Hansen, and Cooper has the football first and 10 from their own 35. First and 10 for the Cougars as they begin their second possession of the ball game with 8 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. No score on the board between the Cougars and the Wildcats. Michael Anderson comes to the line of scrimmage, right hash. And here comes Dominique again, this time over left tackle, and Dominique has the 40-yard line. A gain of 5, it will bring up second and 5. He's stopped by Andrew Ball, who comes in on the stop. And as we said, second down 5. Dominique Rhodes in the backfield, 195 and a senior. Chad Foreman, the tight end, 81, 195 and a senior. Jesse Sharp, the split end, 175 and a junior. Mark Rao, the flanker, 178 and a sophomore. Anderson rolling to his right. He keeps to the 45, and he's run out of bounds. First down yardage for Michael Anderson on his keeper. Coaching staff wants the unsportsmanlike for Anderson being bumped a little bit more. Also for the Cougars, Corey Rodriguez starts at the eight back, 150 and a senior. Up front, Kevin Hoffman, the center, 230 and a senior. The guards, Matt Royal, 64. 265 and a senior. Everett Frazier, 60. 260 and a junior. The tackles, Big Joey Heath, number 75, 290 and a junior. And Webb Murphy, 72, 255 and a junior. First and 10. Cooper has the first down of the ball game for either team. Anderson wants to throw, and the ball knocked down the line of scrimmage. Patrick Hendricks, the nose guard, got good pressure in on Anderson. Hit his arm as you let go of the football. It's incomplete. It'll bring up second and 10.
Patrick Hendricks is not supposed to get in that fast on a two-step drop and rear back and throw, but he was back there very quickly. It looked like a missed assignment. The nose guard just beating off the ball very quickly against the Cougar offensive line. So far, the holes on the running game have been really there for the Cougars early in this ballgame.
Second down 10 for the Cougars. Line of scrimmage, the 47-yard line. Trips left side to the top of the screen. Anderson drops back to pass. Pressure again, throws the screen. Nice catch by Dominique, and he takes a rip at the 49-yard line. Keith Carey, the strong side linebacker, made Dominique Groats pay the price at the 49 to gain of two, and it'll bring up third down and eight.
That's been a play that the Cougars have ran so well in the playoffs, and that one looked like it's set up, but Carey comes a long ways and makes up a lot of ground very quickly, showing good lateral movement on that play, and he delivered a blow to Dominique once he got it too. The Cougars looking at third and long.
Third down and nine for Cooper. Right in front of us at the 48-yard line, Anderson drops back to pass, comes underneath, and it's first down yardage and more for Jesse Sharp, who's inside the 40 and down to the 39. First down for Jesse Sharp, who came right back across on the slant. And Michael Anderson wheels and deals one to him, and it's first down yardage for the Cougars. Two first downs in the drive now for Cooper, and they move the sticks.
Well, that's a big play, big third down pickup. For the first time either one of these teams have been able to do that, and a good poise in the pocket for Anderson. We've seen that from the senior since the midway point in this season.
7 minutes to go in the first quarter. Cooper under center with Michael Anderson. He drops back. Here comes Dominique. Bounces off a man to the 40, and Dominique is dragged down about the 36-yard line. Tackle is made by Kip Collins, the strong side defensive end, number 43. Collins really over-pursued on the play, and then he was able to run it down, so a nice play by Kip Collins. He will bring up second down and six from the 36-yard line. Cooper needs to cross the 30 to have first down yardage. Jesse Sharp and Corey Rodriguez come to the bottom of the screen, the right side. Mark Rao goes up top to the left. The ball is at the left hash mark at the 36-yard line. Anderson gives it off to Dominique, who is going to lose yardage back to the 43-yard line. And again, it's Kip Collins in on the stop. And it's going to bring up third and long, and Dominique having a tough time in the early going, Phil.
Well, you just don't see Dominique get tackled one-on-one too much, particularly in his own backfield. But that time, Collins back there, just about the time Dominique received the handoff, and there was just nothing he could do. That's a big play by that young man, and now the Cougars another third and long.
Third down and 10. They will give him back the 40-yard line, so they don't move the ball back to the 43. Sharp goes wide right side. Cooper connected on their last two third downs. Play action fake by Anderson. He looks, fires for Dominique at the 35. 30, 25, Dominique to the 20. And a first down again for the Cougars. The swing pass to Dominique Groves, good for another first down.
Just excellent touch on the ball by Michael Anderson that time. He put it anywhere, the place that the only person who's going to get that ball is Dominique Groves. Hits him in stride. Dominique never broke stride. He had enough speed behind him to get past the defender and pick up the first down. Big play by the Cougars so far in this drive. It's come on third down.
Cougars now in Courtney Martin's field goal range. Jesse Sharp goes to the top, to the left side on first down. Anderson, a pump fake, throws, looking on the fade, and this one's picked off. At the 3-yard line, Rashawn Taylor picks it off, and it's intercepted. And Lake Highlands has the football. Sharp really never had a chance to turn around on that ball. And it's the interception, the second turnover by the Cougars, and Lake Highlands has the ball back, this time at their own 3.
Well, that's something the Cougars have avoided for a long time, and that's turning the ball over a whole lot. They've done it twice here in the first quarter, this time in really the red zone, wanting to get it in on that time. Anderson looked like he needed to throw that ball outside a little more. Just didn't work out.
First and 10. Hightower keeps. Hightower lost the football. It squirts loose, and I think the Cougars are back on at the 6-yard line. We will await the signal as they get the players off, but that ball came squirting out. All of the Cougars say they have possession. No word from an official yet, and there it is. Cooper has their second turnover of the night, and coming up from the bottom of the pile, Kevin Stevenson. Hello!
That's just two times already in this game that Hightower has popped it up in this situation. Now the Cougars inside the 10. Both of these teams throwing a little jitters here in the early going. This time the Cougars really need to make them pay for a fumble deep in Lake Highlands own territory.
Both teams have turned the football over twice. Cooper has it first and goal from the 7-yard line. And we are going to see the power backfield, which means Roy Strahan and Kevin Stevenson checking the ball game. In Lake Highlands, going to see a little of the West Texas bone coming the other direction now. dominates the deep man in the power eye. He gets the call and the carry, and he's tripped up at about the 6-yard line. First man through is number 58 for Lake Highlands. That is Sergio Castillas. A nice play by Castillas, and the line of scrimmage moves back to about the 8. And it will bring up second and goal. And the Cooper offensive line is so far in the early going, has been beaten to the point of attack. Second down goal from the 8-yard line. Full house backfield again. Here comes the sweep for Dominique. A blocker in front. He gets to the 5 before he's stripped up. This time the tackle made by Rashawn Taylor. Check that. It's not Taylor. That is number 2, Anthony Harden. And it brings up third and goal from the 5.
The first time the Cougars had run that sweep, and it looked like it was set up well, but just sneaking in there to make the play, and Dominique couldn't shake the tackle. But the Cougars looked a lot better running that play than they have inside the tackle so far in this ballgame. It'll be interesting to see what they come up here on third down.
Cooper will send 4 men wide. Chad Foreman and Jesse Sharp to the right. Now Sharp in motion left on third down. Anderson keeps. Michael Anderson, touchdown! That's a great call for the Cougars because Anderson takes the snap. It looked like a passing situation, and Anderson just goes right side, sweeps it into the end zone, and the Cougars lead 6-0.
We've talked about Michael Anderson looking better and better each week, running the football. It's twice tonight. He's picked up good yardage, and that time the touchdown. The Cougars do make them pay on the second turnover, and so far in this ballgame, Cooper 3-for-3 on third downs. They are showing the poise of a team must have at this level.
Courtney Martin for the point after, out of the hold of Scott Copeland. The snap is good. The kick is up. And the kick is good. 3 minutes, 35 seconds to go in the first quarter. Cooper has the lead. It's 7-0 against the Lake Highlands Wildcats here on Cable Channel 7. Plays 8 yards, 1 minute, 15 seconds. Michael Anderson, a 5-yard touchdown run on the sweep. Courtney Martin has added the point after, and Cooper leads it 7-0. And Phil, the early battle now has been won by Cooper because both teams have turned the ball over twice.
Well, the field position has been in the Cougars' favor in this half, and they finally made them pay on the second turnover. And what you like about so far how this game has unfolded is the Cougars have been able to do things without Dominique breaking a big play. They're still making third downs in the passing game. Dominique had a part in that, but the running game for Dominique usually really evolves later in the game, and that's what you got to hope for here. But you get on top of this team early that likes the wishbone, no pass offense. Extremely important.
Roy Strahan to kick it off. Terrence Jefferson is the deep man amongst the 3. Strahan kicks it. It comes down to Jefferson at the 10-yard line. 15-20. Terrence Jefferson to the 25 and tripped up as he crosses the 25-yard line. Eric Gobert, I believe, in on the stop. It is number 43, and it'll be 1st and 10 for Lake Highlands. From the 28-yard line. 3 minutes 29 seconds to go, first quarter. Cooper leads by a touchdown.
So far, the Cooper defense has not allowed Lake Highlands a first down. They have been on top of all the options so far. Let's see if they can keep it up.
DeVore and Hightower comes back to the line of scrimmage. Again, Cooper has all 11 men in the box, double tight end formation. The handoff comes to the first man through, Sam Needham, and Needham gets to the 30-yard line. Gain of maybe 1.5 yards. It'll bring up second down. Matt Garrett at the bottom of the pile along with Charlie Andrade for the Cougars. And it will bring up second down. And again, Joe Krausen, we come back to that storyline because Krausen worked with the man that invented the wishbone, Emory Ballard. And I think if anybody can know how to stop the wishbone, it'll be Krausen. More on that in just a moment. Second down 8. Fort Lake Highlands, under 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. DeVore and Hightower comes to the line of scrimmage. Triple option offense with 3 in the backfield. Hightower will keep, comes across the right side, and he gets to the 35-yard line before he is tripped up. Tackle is made by David O'Shields. 175-pound junior in there for the Cougars.
Joe Krausen talked a little bit about David O'Shields today. When I talked to him before we left Abilene, he loves that free safety, the strong safety, David O'Shields. He says he knows usually more about the opponents than some of the coaches even. He is really a student of the game and a big-time player in the last part of this season.
Third down and three. Hightower keeps. Hightower has the first down, gets to the 40, maybe the 41-yard line. But the first down of the ball game for Lake Highlands. Last week, the winning touchdown drive for Lake Highlands was not led by DeVoren Hightower. Towards the end of the game, it was Sean Stilley who came in the game. Hightower was injured. Hightower, actually, I take that back, scored the touchdown that put Lake Highlands ahead of Tyler John Tyler. But at the end, when they were trying to run out the clock, it was Sean Stilley in the ball game. He is the man that they say passes the ball, although they don't pass much. First and 10 for the Wildcats, 41-yard line, and up the middle is Needham. And Needham gets to about the 44-yard line. Boy, Hightower almost lost that football again as he was wrapped up just as he was making the exchange with his running back.
Well, that's one of the dangers of the wishbone. You do a lot of faking, a lot of pitching in the backfield, and you can turn it over. And if the Cougars can get some penetration and disrupt things in the backfield, they, as you can see, they can force some turnovers. The Wildcats have already fumbled it twice.
Second down, six. For Lake Highlands, 45-yard line, their own 45, the line of scrimmage. Hightower keeps, and Hightower gets to about the 48-yard line. Eric Gobert in there trying to strip the football away. It's going to bring up third down. One of the interesting things, Phil, that we talk about with the wishbone is the talk that Joe Krausen was giving us earlier today about the gap defense. Let's talk about that for a moment.
Well, Jimmy, it's gap defense is what Cooper has played all season. That's their scheme. But when you get it up against a wishbone team, it becomes an assignment defense. You have to change everything. And so the Cougars have been working very hard on that this week.
Thus far, the assignment's working out very well. Third down, a short three. Hightower keeps. Hightower down the left side is dragged down at about the 48-yard line. Eric Gobert pulls down to DeVoren Hightower, but not before Hightower picks up the first down. And you can start to see the assignment. Eric Gobert is going to be assigned the job of chasing or being the shadow of DeVoren Hightower tonight.
Well, that time, that's one of those scary looks when Hightower pulls out of that fake and comes outside and there's not a whole lot of white jerseys out there. That time, Gobert runs him down from behind. Nice play. Eric Gobert, the fastest of these linebackers, and you're right, he's the man that's going to have to handle Hightower on this side of the field.
First and 10 for the Wildcats from the Cooper 48-yard line. Hightower again, the 45, and he's down to about the 43-yard line. Hightower and Needham, about 80% of the offense for Lake Highlands. They don't really go to the halfbacks a lot because Hightower is so good, and Hightower has brought us down to the last play of the first quarter. We have played one quarter from Texas Stadium in Irving with our score, Cooper 7, Richardson Lake Highlands 0. You're watching the state semifinal game of Division II right here on Cable Channel 7.
To stop drug use, I think it's going to take more than a just say no campaign. It's so easy to tell somebody just say no, but you've got to give them the power to say no. You have to decide whether to compromise yourself or not. You have to decide whether you're going to help people or whether you're going to hurt people. You have to decide, what's important to you. Where are your priorities? I'm no stronger than the next guy. I've got to be able to make wise decisions in my own life and know that that's what I want to do.
Life. You're born, you're all potential, like a blank slate. You get to fill it any way you want. Nah. You're a canvas. Yeah, you're like a brand new canvas you can go wild on. Nah, maybe you're more like a lump of clay that can be molded into anything. Well, the idea is simple. Fill up your life. Just keep drugs out of it, huh? After all, your life is the only whatever you got. It's a life or drugs situation.
Ready? second quarter begins here at Texas Stadium. Second down, 5 for Lake Highlands. I'm Jimmy Pogue along with Phil Ashby. Rob Westman, Randy Kluck, and Eddie Raines, our Cable Channel 7 crew tonight. We're glad you're tuned in with us. Don't forget, at halftime tonight, you can see the awesome Cooper Marching Band under the direction of our good friend Anthony Gibson. We will watch that coming up later. Second down, 5 for Lake Highlands. DeWarren Hightower, the quarterback, is under center. Full house backfield with him out of the wishbone. Gives it off to Needham, and he is stuffed right in the middle of the line. Charlie Andrade is there. Roy Strahan is there, and Kevin Stevenson is there, and it brings up third down.
A little strength of that defensive line right there by the Cougars. The one I saw was Kevin Stevenson. He just would not let go, and he showed a lot of strength. Needham really doesn't get much on that play. So far in this situation, the Cougars have won these third and short plays. Let's see if they can do it again.
Third down and 3. Thus far, the only two men to touch the ball for Lake Highlands, DeWarren Hightower and Sam Needham. Third down, 3. Hightower keeps it on the option. Hightower runs into Melvin Barnes, but he has the first down at the Cooper 34-yard line. Another first down picked up by the 188-pound senior, DeWarren Hightower. And again, like we said, Melvin Barnes in on the stop. Interesting enough, Phil, that only two men have touched the football so far for Lake Highland.
They each have 7 carries. It's just been Needham up the middle, Hightower outside. But we've seen Hightower's strength. He likes to turn it up inside the tackles most of the time. He's a big boy. He can run over some people.
First and 10. Hightower on the option. Here comes the pitch back to Terrence Jefferson to the 30, 25. Jefferson inside the 20, stepped out of bounds back at the 23-yard line. So Terrence Jefferson takes the option pitch from Hightower, turns it outside, gets to the 23. It's enough for another first down for Lake Highland. As the sticks will move once again.
Peter Abrig
pushes him out of bounds for the Cougars. First and 10, Lake Highlands, just underway. Second quarter. We played a minute of the second quarter. Cooper up 7-0, but Lake Highlands is on the move. Hightower again comes to the line of scrimmage. The 11th play of the drive for Lake Highlands. Hightower hands it off to Needham. Needham breaks one off inside the 20, the 15, and down to the 11-yard line. One of the things the Cooper coaches were worried about, Phil, was the fact that Lake Highlands can keep a defense on the field for a long time, and Cooper's defense does give up some yardage.
Well, as Joe Crowther said, they're just not the type of defense that gets a lot of 3-and-outs. We've seen a couple here tonight, but they usually do grudgingly give up some yardage. So far on this drive, this is exactly what they feared, just taking the ball down the field, keeping it away from that Cooper offense.
12th play of the drive coming up for Lake Highlands. The Cooper crowd comes to their feet. First and 10. Hightower again keeps inside the 10. Hightower inside the 5 and a touchdown. DeWarren Hightower scores from 13 yards out. And it's 7-6.
Well, that's what Hightower can do. He can cut up against the grain inside. It looked like Kobe Ford was there waiting for Hightower, and Hightower was just that quick step, steps inside and then beats everybody to the end zone, and Lake Highlands looking for the equalizing kick here as they go down the field really in a methodical fashion.
Seth Hansen for the point after. Out of the hold of Sean Stilley, the kick is up. And the kick is good. 10 minutes, 31 seconds to go in the first half. We're tied at 7 here on Cable Channel 7. Richardson Lake Highlands go 13 plays, 72 yards in 5 minutes and 4 seconds. DeWarren Hightower, a 13-yard touchdown run. Seth Hansen has had the point after. We're tied at 7. And And back deep for the Cougars, Dominic Rose, along with Robbie Johnson. And Hansen sets to kick it off, the left footer. Sidewinding kick, Robbie Johnson fields at the 2, to the 5, 10, 15. He's got a lane at the 20. 25 and out to the 28-yard line comes Robbie Johnson. Good return for Johnson, and so it'll be first and 10 for the Cougars from their own 28-yard line. And Cooper now then needs to have some sort of ball control drive just to give their defense a bit of a rest.
That's real important, Jimmy. That defense was on the field for 13 plays over 5 minutes, and that can wear on you. The Cougars are capable of putting together 10 to 15 play drives. We've seen it several times this year, and that would be really nice right now to give that defense a blow.
First and 10 for the Cougars. Their own 28-yard line, the line of scrimmage. Michael Anderson drops back on first down, takes a hit, throws underneath, the pass is dropped. Dominique doesn't drop many, but he drops this one. And it will bring up second and 10, and Michael Anderson took a little shot to the ribs about the time he got rid of the football.
Well, we see Dominique out wide on that play and coming in to get the ball. We haven't seen that play that I can remember this season, and it looked like it was there. Dominique, I think, took his eye off and looked upfield a little bit just dropped it.
Second and 10 for the Cougars from the 28-yard line. 10:21 to go in the first half. Anderson drops back to pass again, this time looking long, a pump fake. This one blocked up in the air, and it's incomplete. Almost picked off by Aaron Ball. Corey Rodriguez, a nice job of coming back for the football, actually maybe playing a little defensive back there to knock it away, because Aaron Ball looked like he was going to make the catch on that.
And the worst part about the first two plays of this drive is it has taken no time off the clock, and now the Cougars are looking at a third and 10, and if they don't pick this up, that defense has to go right back out on the field and absorb some more pounding, so this is a key play here.
Third down 10 for the Cougars. Two men to the top of the screen. Anderson drops back to pass, setting the screen. Here comes Corey Aldridge at the 30-35. It's a block from Mark Brown down the sideline, midfield, into Lake Highlands territory, and Aldridge has the first down. Again, a nice call, the screen pass, and Corey Aldridge has the catch and big yardage and another first down.
Well, the third down play calling and the execution has just been outstanding for the Cougars in the first half. It seems like they're in disarray on offense the first two plays. They come up with a big play like that. That tight end screen has been so big in the playoffs. Corey Aldridge showing he can run it, and that's a nice job by the blockers, just well executed.
First and 10 for the Cougars from the 43-yard line of Lake Highlands. Tied at 7 under 10 minutes. Anderson hands it off to Dominique on the draw. Dominique gets back maybe to the line of scrimmage and nothing more. Maybe the 44-yard line before he is brought down. Tackle is made by Justin Penny, the weak side end. Now Cooper up front on the offensive line, tackle to tackle, averaging 260 pounds. With their tight end in the ball game, they go to 249. However, Lake Highlands only 207 up front, but they're playing that five-man front, maybe confusing a little bit here in the early going. Second down 12, a loss of 2 on the play for Dominique. From the 45-yard line, Michael Anderson takes the snap. Hands it off to Dominique again. Quick hitter this time. He's inside the 40 and down to about the 38-yard line.
Well, if Dominique can get past the first wave, we all know what he can do. That time, no one there to meet the line of scrimmage, and he hits the line of scrimmage really hard, and he gets that burst of speed and can really put some hurt on you when he's in the secondary with a full steam ahead.
Third down and 4 for the Cougars from the 37-yard line. Under center. Cougars 4-of-4 on third down. Low pitch for Dominique, and they will not get the first down here. Good pressure initially from Patrick Hendricks. Michael Anderson took a hit just about the time he pitched the football. Dominique Rhodes made a nice catch of the pitch, but then is had to slow down a little bit, lost a bit of momentum, and it brings up fourth down, and now then the Cougars will send out the punting unit. Mark Rowell, the sophomore, will punt it away for the Cougars.
Well, it's a nice drive. At least they did not give it up, and they're going to get the field position back that they had earlier in this game and Rao can really pooch it down inside the 10-yard line.
No one is deep for Lake Highlands. Rao's punt, very high. It bounces at the 10, and it's a great punt for Mark Rao as it will bounce out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Lake Highlands will have the football back, but Mark Rao got off a nice spiraling punt. And with 7 minutes and 44 seconds to go in the first half, Lake Highlands has the ball deep in their end at their own 9-yard line with this ballgame tied at 7.
Well, this is a key stand for the Cooper defense, who just gave up a 13-play drive the last time the Wildcats had the ball. This time, the Wildcats are going to have much longer to go, but the Cougar defense could really help themselves by forcing a punt deep in the Wildcats territory.
Warren Hightower under center, first and 10. Hightower gives it off with his fullback, Sam Needham, and Needham crosses the 10, gets maybe to the 12-yard line. Not a lot of room in there for Needham. He's tackled by the middle of the line. It'll bring up second down. Call it a gain of 3, so we'll call it second and 7. Roy Strahan was there on the stop for the Cougars. Sounds like almost a Monday night football type atmosphere here on Friday night here on Cable Channel 7. We look through the hole in the roof so God can watch the team play. Isn't that what they say?
That's what they say.
Hightower on second down, second and 7. Strong side to the left side. Hightower keeps, turns it upfield, and he's brought down. Roy.
Talent for the chance to share his passion.
the Partita number 2 in C minor by Johann Sebastian Bach in a wonderful performance by our third young artist in residence here at Performance Today, pianist Anne-Marie McDermott. Alas, we're out of time, Anne-Marie, and we'll have to talk to you again tomorrow on N.
Ready to really let it burn, and that about that time it looked like Aldridge and Trahan tripped him up, and that's now a 3rd and 5, and that's a little tougher than to get that 3rd and 2 and 3 that they had a lot on the last drive.
Ball at 3rd down and 4 from the 15 because Lake Highlands does not have to have the 24 at first down. Big 3rd down play. The play clock down to 3. Hightower will keep. Hightower trying to get outside is tripped up at the 20-yard line. Eric Gilbert is in on the stop, but it should be enough for the first down for Devon Hightower.
Well, that time Hightower showing a little of the strength as he just took a man and leaned forward and goes for the first down, and he gets it right at the 20-yard line.
And DeVarn Hightower is limping off the field at the 35-yard line. We get our camera shot over there. Hightower had a leg injury last week and was not able to finish the win against Tyler John Tyler. And so now then we see Sean Stilley in the ballgame at quarterback. And we will check the progress of DeVarn Hightower as we move along. Stilley on 1st and 10 for Lake Highlands from the 20-yard line. Hands it off to Needham, and Needham is pushed back. Sam Needham, nothing going right there. Eric Gilbert is there. Kevin Stevenson is there. And they push the line back. Now that with Hightower out of the ball game, at least momentarily, Phil, I think Cooper can really focus on Sam Needham.
Well, that's where they're going to go. That's that first option. That time Roy Strahan just stood him up at the line of scrimmage with a big, strong play. He comes out for a rest, and Myers Ray takes his play.
Stilley now 2nd and 10. Full house backfield. Needham, the fullback, with a big load on his shoulders with DeVarn Hightower out, and there is a met quarterback and fullback at the line of scrimmage. Flags are down. I'm not sure the ball didn't come loose. Cooper may be offsides on this. We'll wait and see the official's ruling. But right in the middle of the line, the Cougars just pounce in there. It's a legal motion against Lake Highlands, and I believe Cooper is about to decline this to bring up 3rd and 10. They will wave it off. It will be 3rd down and 11. And now then, it looks like Sean Stilley will throw the first pass of the ballgame. Justin Smith, number 7, has come into the ballgame as a wide receiver. 5 minutes, 11 seconds to go in the first half. Smith goes wide to the left side. Jason Eldridge comes wide to the right on 3rd down. Stilley tries to hand it off, and he's decked right at the line of scrimmage. May have lost a yard, and it brings up 4th down. Kevin Stevenson again on the stop for the Cougars, and it will bring up the 4th down.
What did Kevin Stevenson pounce on that play? He was back there, and the quarterback Stilley couldn't even get going, and that's a big stand by this defense as the Cougars stop them at the 20-yard line and will get the ball back. Dominique back deep to receive the punt.
Seth Hansen to punt it away for Lake Highlands. Dominic Rhodes, Robbie Johnson deep. Here comes the rush. The Cougars almost had that one. Robbie Johnson makes the goal for the fair catch at the 47-yard line of Cooper. And the Cougars will have it 1st and 10 after a 33-yard punt from Seth Hansen. 4 minutes, 18 seconds to go in the first half. We're tied at 7. Cooper and Lake Highlands, but the big news, DeVarn Hightower went limping off the field. It's the same leg that bothered him last week.
Looked almost like the way he was limping, almost like a hip pointer or something like that.
Well, last week we were happened to be listening to that ball game as we drove home to Abilene, and they weren't sure what the problem was at that time, but it's something maybe of a cramp or a strain down there. But he went off very gingerly off the field, and it looked like that Lake Highlands offense really deflated after he went out. Cooper stopped him 3 plays, no yardage.
The officials are having a conversation with Randy Allen on the near sideline. I'm not positive about this. I think they want the band to move. I think that's what the word is, because we see one of the Cooper assistants talking with Anthony Gibson, the band director at Cooper. And That may be what they want. I'm not sure. Anthony Gibson, a marked man here in Texas Stadium. First and 10 for the Cougars. Dominique Rhodes, the lone setback. Standing at the 40-yard line, Cougar fans come to their feet. Here comes Dominique. Dominique swarmed under after maybe a gain of two. Kip Collins again on the stop. And this Lake Highlands defense, of all the teams we have seen this year so far, Phil, has done the best job of stopping Dominique.
Well, we haven't seen Dominique have this much trouble getting going since, I don't, early in the season before this win streak, Bob, for sure. He's still bound to break a few, and there were some holes there early, but it's been tough here in the second quarter.
Second down, Michael Anderson, play action rolling out. He's got some room. Needs a block. Got one by Copeland, and Anderson is decked at the 45. He is shy of the first down, and Michael Anderson gets up. He's waiting for a block for Scott from Scott Copeland, who's in playing the A-back. And it's going to bring up third down, a long three.
Copeland was wide open as he went out that. Anderson, I think, is liking this running on the bootleg, and he just takes it upfield and then gets close to the first down. And now another third down. The Cougars missed on their last third down for the first time in this game. They're 4 for 5.
Third down, a short three for the Cougars. Mark Rao goes out wide to the right side, along with Scott Copeland. Now then, Chad Foreman comes to the left side along with Jesse Sharp on third down. Inside handoff to Dominique. He's tripped up at the 45. Tackle is made on the play for Lake Highlands by number 58, Sergio Castillejos. Had a nice first half, but it's going to bring up fourth and two and an interesting play call now with 3:24 to go in the first half. Cooper's at the Lake Highlands 45. If you don't get the first down, Lake Highlands has time, but they sputtered last time without their starting quarterback, DeVarren Hightower.
They're putting in the short yardage offense here as Strahan and Stevenson will come into the backfield. You wonder if the injury to Hightower is playing into the decision at all with about 3 minutes to go in the second half. You don't want to give them the ball right here, and the Cougars will take a timeout and talk about it as they were running very close to the end of that 25-second clock.
Play clock had got down to 2 seconds, so Cooper takes the timeout. It is their first timeout. So with 2:54 to go in the first half, Cooper takes the timeout. We're tied at 7. Cooper faces fourth down and 2. And I really think in this situation, even though you got that power running game in, I think you may see something like what we saw last week, Texas and Nebraska. I think Michael Anderson may have to throw the ball because Dominique has had a hard time.
Well, he has had a hard time. Blake Collins doing a nice job of tackling, and Dominique just can't break loose. The last play on third down looked like a huge hole there. Dominique had room to get the first down and somebody trips him from behind. Blake Collins doing a nice job of doing that. So far on this third down, the Cougars have on third downs, so the Cougars have come up with a variety of plays, and the screen has worked a couple of times.
Third down and 2 for the Cougars. Fourth and 2. Big play of the ball game. And now then the Cougars have decided to punt, and I think this is a good call. We will talk about this in just a moment. But Mark Rao stands back at the 42-yard line. The snap is there. And Rao gets the kick away. It's fielded at the 10-yard line by Travis McElroy, and McElroy is going to go down at the 10-yard line. Corey Aldridge, I believe, the first man down the field for the Cougars.
Life. You're born, you're all potential, like a blank slate. Fill it any way you want. You're like a lump of clay that can be molded into anything. Fill up your life. Just keep drugs out, huh? It's a life or drugs situation.
Do you think you have the power to change the world?
I can change the world one child at a time.
I know I can make a difference in those children's lives.
I teach.
Yes, they're teachers, but to the kids they reach, they're heroes.
I teach.
Do you have the power to wake up young minds, to be someone's hero? Teach, to make an impact on our future. Call 1-800-45-TEACH. Be a teacher. Be a hero.
Why would anybody give someone they don't know a gift? They do it because this gift saves lives. And the need for it is desperate. Please give blood. There's a life to be saved right now. Call the American Red Cross at 1-800-GIVE-LIFE.
First and 10 for the Wildcats. And it's Sean Stille, still a quarterback. On first down, Stille keeps, gets out to the 15-yard line. Eric Gobert is there. And also David O'Shields. O'Shields, the man, will be credited with a tackle to bring up second down. And Stille was almost popped behind the line of scrimmage.
Stille, a big boy, too. He doesn't go down easily. He runs 6'4", 201. Two big quarterbacks to run the wishbone for this Wildcat offense.
And I don't see DeVar and Hightower anywhere around on the sideline for Lake Highlands. Second down, 5 from the 15. Stille keeps. Now the long pitch comes back for Drew Harden, and Harden's first carry of the ball game gets a first down out across the 24, maybe the 25-yard line. But it will be enough for the first down for Lake Highlands with 2 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the first half. I think, Phil, right now, if you're Lake Highlands, you've got to want to just get into the dressing room, having kept the football and not giving Cooper another chance with your quarterback, Lauren Hightower, out of the ballgame.
Particularly with the field position they're in right now, they've really not broken a long run at all on the Cougars, and with Hightower, the probability is even less.
First and 10, Hightower wants to pass. He does, and this one's incomplete, but there's a flag. Melvin Barnes has a bit of a wreck over there with Jason Eldridge. And it will be a first down for Lake Highlands.
Well, you see on that play, the first pass of the game for Lake Highlands, and a pretty good coverage, and I think they'll get Josh Button from climbing the back on that play. The back judge makes that call. The side judge let it go, but that's the first pass of the game against this Cougar defense that is really devoting 10 players to the run, and you just got to hope they don't connect. That time the Cougars all over the pass, but the situation with 2 minutes left in the first half, they have to be aware that this might be the situation Lake Highlands throws the ball.
Brent Worthy comes out wide to the right side. Going to the left, Justin Smith. Keeping the ball is Stille, and Stille is dragged down. Matt Garrett is there along with Eric Gobert behind the line of scrimmage at the 35. Loss of about 3 on the play. It'll bring up second down and 13.
Cougars all over that, and you can see that Stille is just not as quick as escaping out of the fakes inside as Hightower in, and the Cougars have twice just really been all over him in the backfield, and that's a key. If they can get back there and knock that ball loose, we'll take it.
Minute 25 to go in the first half, second down 12. Stille keeps, and he crosses the 35 to about the 37-yard line. Eric Gobert again is having a fantastic game, and it will bring up third down and 11, and the clock runs inside of a minute 10. Charlie Andrade also in on the stop for the Cougars. Third down and long now for Lake Highlands. We reach 1 minute to go in the first half. Coming to the right side is Justin Smith. He is the lone wideout on third down and 11. Sean Stille at the quarterback takes the snap. Stille keeps, gets to the 40, and he is brought down at the 43-yard line. And let's see if Cooper burns their second timeout here. 40 seconds. The defensive coaches want the timeout called, and now then they will call the timeout with 37 seconds. 37 seconds to go in the first half. We're tied at 7. Cooper uses their second timeout, but they're going to get the football back, Phil.
Well, it would have been nice if the Cougars had not had to use that timeout the last time they had the ball. They could have used one on third and long and really had more time to work with here, but this time the timeout right before the punt. We've seen the Cougars use this situation and score some points in the playoffs.
Cooper will send Dominique Rhodes and Robbie Johnson deep to accept the punt of Seth Hansen. Dominique Rhodes has broken a couple of punts off this year for touchdowns. And Cooper has been very good in the waning moments of the first half and the opening moments of the second half. And we're in that situation now. 37 seconds to go in the first half. Cooper will have the ball for the waning moments, and then they have the ball to open the second half.
You're right, Jimmy, and the Cougars, and that's been the key to a couple of their wins this year, is the ability to score right before the half and then come back and put another score on the board right after the half. Nothing would be sweeter right now, but so far, Dominique having a hard time getting going in this game, but he's due.
Here's Hansen's punt. High kick, Dominique Rhodes. At the 25 is buried just as he makes the catch. Tackle is made on the play by Granger Smith, number 11. And there is a flag down. If this may be interference against Lake Highlands, because Dominique was ripped just as he made the catch. And even if he wants to return the punt, you cannot hit him before the ball gets there. And it is interference against Lake Highlands, so this is going to give Cooper decent field position. It's a 15-yard penalty, which is going to take Cooper out across their own 40 to about the 42. Now, this, with 29 seconds to go in the half, has just opened up Randy Allen's playbook.
You're right. He likes these situations. He probably wishes he had a little more than 29 seconds, but Martin, with a good leg, he's got range in the 40-yard mark. Wouldn't be nice to end this half with some points.
Cooper will send Mark Rao, Jesse Sharp, and Corey Rodriguez all to the bottom of our screen. Rao is the wide man out, Sharp in the middle. Now then, Dominique Rhodes comes in motion, and Anderson throws it outside for Dominique on first down. Dominique back across the field for Michael Anderson, four men in front of him. Anderson to midfield. Anderson to the 40, and he's knocked out at the 35. First down, Cooper. But it's the lateral to Dominique, who turns right back around and throws across for Michael Anderson. And Anderson had Everett Frazier and company in front. First down, Cooper, inside the 40, down to the 37-yard line.
21 yards on that play. It seemed like it was never going to unfold, but once it did, it was all set up as the convoy was over there, and Anderson just followed it and then did the smart thing and got out of bounds, and the Cougars are now in scoring position.
Kevin Hoffman was also out there for the Cougars, first and 10. Anderson again drops back the pass, looks for the sideline, has Jesse Sharp inside the 30 at the 29. And the clock winds down to 14 seconds to go in the half, but Cooper still with time. Sharp gains about 8 on the play. It'll bring up 2nd and 2. From the 30, Cooper is on the move. This started at the Cooper 43-yard line. Anderson will send Mark Rao and Corey Rodriguez to the left. Jesse Sharp goes wide to the right. Anderson takes the snap, fires on the outside for Rodriguez. It's incomplete. Down to 11 seconds to go. Right there in coverage for Lake Highlands, the strong safety, John Patton. And I believe on that play, Patton would have been able to bring down Rodriguez before he would have gotten out of bounds. So it at least saves Cooper from having to spend their last time out.
You're right, Jimmy. He might have not been able. That's a timing pattern. Anderson has to make the throw before Rodriguez can turn around, and it just got there before Rodriguez was expecting. It might have worked out okay. Cougars looking at 3rd down now, though.
3rd down and 3 for Cooper. Anderson, a quick drop, looks down the field. Flags are down. The pass is incomplete. This should be a hold against Cooper, and it will be interesting to see what Lake Highlands would decide to do with this if it is a hold. I would think that they would take the penalty and give Cooper the down over again. It is indeed a hold against Cooper, but Courtney Martin at the moment is in range. Albeit long range, he is in range. And so the option stands with Lake Highlands. It would be a 48-yard field goal attempt before the penalty. Before the penalty, it would be a 48-yard attempt. So Lake Highlands takes no chances here. They will take the penalty. And it will take the ball back to the 40-yard line. So 7 seconds to go. We have seen Cooper run a hook and lateral here. Maybe they try that. Here comes Mark Rao to the left side along with Corey Rodriguez. Jesse Sharp goes wide to the right. Play action fake by Anderson. Stands in the pocket and he throws one up for grabs. And this one is going to be picked off. It was blocked as it was being thrown. And Travis McElroy makes the interception. Michael Anderson slow in getting up. But we come to the end of the first half of play with our score, Cooper 7, Lake Highlands 7. You get a free look at the awesome Cooper Band, along with the Cougarettes. Enjoy the halftime here on Cable Channel 7.
Thank you. Thank you.
Semifinals between the Cooper Cougars and the Lake Highlands Wildcats, and we are knotted at 7 here at Texas Stadium. I'm Jimmy Vogue along with Phil Ashby here on Cable Channel 7 tonight, and Phil's got the numbers of the first half.
Extremely even first half. Here's how the numbers look. Cooper 6 first downs, Lake Highlands 8. In the rushing department, Cooper really shut down in the first half by the Wildcat defense. Only 37 yards on the ground for Cooper in 14 carries. Lake Highlands, 29 rushes, 113 yards. Cooper through the air, 92 yards. Michael Anderson, 5 of 11 with 2 interceptions. Total yardage, Cooper, 129 yards. Of course, Lake Highlands, 0 passing yardage. They threw one pass, a pass interference penalty, wiped it out, so 0 passing yards. Total yardage in the first half, Cooper 129, Lake Highlands 113. Fumbles, Cooper loses 1, Lake Highlands loses 2, so a total of 5 turnovers in that first half. Punts, Mark Rowell for Cooper, 2 punts for a 30.5 average. Lake Highlands, 3 punts for a 31-yard average. In the penalty department, Cooper flagged twice for 25 yards. Lake Highlands twice for 20 yards. Dominique Rhodes on the ground in the first half, 11 rushes, 20 yards. Michael Anderson, 3 rushes, 17 yards, and a touchdown. For Lake Highlands, Hightower, the quarterback, 11 rushes, 45 yards, and a touchdown before going out with an injury late in the second half. The fullback, Sam Needham, 11 carries, 37 yards, and the backup quarterback, Stilley, 5 rushes, 11 yards for Lake Highlands. Passing, Michael Anderson, 5 of 11, 2 interceptions, the last one on the last play of the first half, 71 yards through the air for Anderson, but he also caught a pass. Dominique Rhodes with a throwback, Rhodes 1 for 1 for 21 yards on that play. Leading receivers for the Cougars in the first half, Dominique Rhodes, 2 receptions, 22 yards. Jesse Sharp, 2 catches, 20 yards. Corey Aldridge, 1 catch on the tight end screen for 29 yards. And then Michael Anderson with his 1 reception for 21 yards. Cooper with a slight edge in total yardage because of the passing game, but a very even first half, and we're tied at 7-7.
Well, as we take a look at that first half also, take away 1 interception. I think you have to say that last interception of the half, Michael Anderson was hit just as he let go of the football. It did no damage because that brought us to the end of the half. So really that one, you know, if you can have a turnover that you like, I guess that would be the one that ended a half. But in the second half, Cooper has got to do something to get Dominique Rhodes on track. But don't blame Dominique for this one, because this Lake Highland defense has been something special in the first half.
They have been all over Dominique on most plays. He's had a couple of seams, really the first series was the most effective. But so far, his longest rush of that first half was 7 yards, and Dominique just not used, or neither does Cooper offensive line used to being bottled up that much.
Back deep for the Cougars to accept the kickoff. Dominique Rhodes along with Robbie Johnson and Richard Rodriguez. And Seth Hansen to kick it off. 24 minutes of football remaining in the state semifinal of Division II. The kickoff is high and deep, and it will come down to Dominique Rhodes at the 1 yard line. To the 5, 10, 15, 20. Dominique breaks it to the outside. Gets to the 25, the 30. 35, 40 for Dominique. 45, and he gets to midfield. And there's a late hit that's going to add 15 to the play.
Chad Foreman with a big block on the side, and Dominique slips out of the only really guy that had a chance at him until he's knocked out of bounds at about the 30. That's something Dominique hadn't done much in the first half, make people miss. He does there. That might be the big play. You know, the Cougars in the second half last week looked like a different ball team. If that's some kind of spark with a penalty, they're going to have the ball about at the 30-yard line to start the second half.
First and 10 for the Cougars. And this is going to move the football 15 yards down the field to the Lake Highlands 35-yard line. Put a little start by that play because this is huge to open the second half.
The first and 10 to go for the Cougars.
35-yard line for the Cougars. Mark Rao will go wide to the right side. Coming out wide to the left, Jesse Sharp along with Corey Rodriguez. Now Dominique goes in motion. Cooper setting the screen and Michael Anderson throwing it out of bounds. It was a loose ball. Interesting play because Webb Murphy came all the way out wide on the play. It is a loss all the way back to the 45-yard line. People are going to wonder about that, thinking incomplete pass, but that ball is loose. It's a fumble because it was a lateral, and that is going to be a loss of about 10 yards, a loss of 9 for the Cougars.
And that hurts on first down to set yourself up with the second and 19. But I think Anderson did the right thing. When he looked over there, Lake Collins had that one all covered. And the best thing to do is to throw it in the ground if you've already started that throw and can't hold up. But second and 19 is not the way you wanted to start after the momentum of the kickoff return.
Second down, 19. Anderson, quick pass, comes out for Rao. Rao turns it upfield to the 40, 35. Mark Rao in the open field at the 30. 25 with a stiff arm, and Mark Rao is down to the 23. John Patton makes the stop to save the touchdown, and Mark Rao gets a first down.
Sophomore doing a nice job of breaking tackles on that play. We saw Mark Rao do that against Midland Lee in his best ball game. That time, a little short, out to Rao, and he just does the rest, breaks tackles, and gets a couple of good blocks downfield. Big turnaround, second and 19 to pick up that first down.
First and 10 for the Cougars. Line of scrimmage, the 22 of Lake Highlands. Twins to the top for Cooper. Here comes a little counter for Dominique, spinning out of one tackle. He gets to the 21 before he's brought down. The tackle is made on the play by number 94, Keith Carey, the strong side linebacker, who stepped immediately up into the hole that was open. Gain of a yard, maybe a yard and a half. It'll bring up second and 8. 11 minutes to go, third quarter, opening drive. Dominique Rhodes returned the opening kickoff 50 yards to midfield, and a 15-yard personal foul for a late hit. Moved the ball to the 35. Cooper lost 9 yards on a lateral for Michael Anderson. It's to Dominique Rhodes, got it right back with a pass to Mark Rao. Here comes Rao again. Blockers in front, inside the 10 he goes, and it's a first down. First and goal, Cooper. Inside the 10 at the 9-yard line.
And the job by the offensive line, as we see Joey Heath and others get out there so far away from the line of scrimmage so quickly and set up those little screens to the wide receivers, are just amazing. The offensive linemen carrying that much weight and getting out in front of and making blocks downfield.
First and goal from just inside the 10-yard line. A minute and a half into the third quarter. Rao goes wide right side. The sophomore playing big in this one. Anderson on first down, hands it off to Dominique, and Dominique gets down to about the 6 before he is brought down. In the middle again is Keith Carey in on the stop, and it will bring him second and goal.
And the Cooper coaching staff has got to hope that some of those quick passes just kind of spreads out the defense a little bit and gives some lanes to Dominique Rhodes. So far, it hasn't, but they're doing a nice job of picking up first downs in other ways.
Second and goal, line of scrimmage, the 6. Dominique, the lone setback, stands at the 11, now backs up to about the 13. From the left hash mark, strips to the top of the screen. The handoff to Dominique inside the 5, leaning for the 4. Before he is brought down, and Keith Carey again in on the stop, and it's going to bring up third and goal.
Lake Highlands has just not given anything inside the tackles. They have been outstanding along the defensive line. When the Cougars can get out wide and get those big offensive linemen moving, they've had success. But really up the tackles, Lake Highlands doing the job.
Third down and goal. All three receivers very close to the tackle. Play action fake by Anderson. Fires for the corner, is caught. Corey Rodriguez to the 1, dive, touchdown! Corey Rodriguez has his first touchdown of the season, and the Cougars lead it 13-7.
Hello, Corey. Corey Rodriguez just wanted that end zone. As the quarterback Harden comes up, makes a hit, Corey just bounces off of it and leans over, first touchdown of the season. Could have been a bigger one.
Courtney Martin for the point after. Out of the hole to Scott Copeland. Six-yard touchdown pass, Michael Anderson to Corey Rodriguez. Snap is good, the kick is up, and the kick is good. 9 minutes, 2 seconds to go, third quarter. Cooper takes a 14-7 lead here on Cable Channel 7. Goes 7 plays, 36 yards in 2 minutes, 58 seconds. Corey Rodriguez, a 4-yard touchdown pass for Michael Anderson. Courtney Martin adds the point after it's 14-7. Michael Anderson, 3 of 3 on that drive for the Cougars. And Roy Strahan to kick it off. And back deep is Terrence Jefferson back at the 5-yard line. And Strahan's kick comes to the 10, and this is Drew Harden to the 15, 20, 25, 30. He has a lane, gets out to the 35-yard line. And it will be first and 10 for Lake Highlands from their own 35, and we will wait to see if we see DeVarin Hightower or Sean Stille in at quarterback, and we are going to see Stille. Now that I've got to say this, special moment on that touchdown pass because it's Corey Rodriguez's first touchdown catch of the year. Michael Anderson and Corey Rodriguez, two of our student council officers at Cooper, and two of the nicest guys in the world. And Corey's been saying, throw me the ball, throw me the ball. So he gets one and scores his first touchdown, a big ball game. 14-7, Cooper leads, and here's Stille under center. Takes the ball away from Needham, and he is wrapped up. A loss of a yard on the play. And it will bring up second and 11.
Mac Garrett just bulldozed down Stille on that play as he just barely gets past the line of scrimmage, and Garrett is there to meet him, and Mac Garrett comes out fired up in the second half as another Lake Highland Wildcat limping off after that play.
Second down, they're going to give him to the 36-yard line. Second down, 9 for Lake Highland. Stille comes under center. Now they're checking off the play with 6 to go on the play clock. Stille hands it off, Needham, big hole, trips up at the 45 and is down in midfield. Otherwise, he could have gone the distance. Melvin Barnes falls on top of him, but it's enough for the first down for Sam Needham. I'm looking across the field trying to see DeVarin Hightower at any point across the field. Hightower is number 5, and I can see him now. If you look at about the 47-yard line, the Lake Highlands 47, you see DeVarin Hightower, he does not have a helmet even in his hand, but now that he's walking back behind the bench area. First down. Stille keeps, and down he goes. Corey Aldridge in on the stop for the Cougars, along with Nathan Fort, number 87.
Another good job is they have been all over Stille when he's kept the ball. Needham has hurt him a couple of times with the dive, but ever since Stille has come into the ball game at quarterback, the Cougars have been all over the quarterback when he's kept it. You wonder if he's going to start pitching that ball more. We haven't seen the pitch but twice in this ball game in a quarter, 2 quarters and a half.
Somebody has got to step up for Lake Highlands. Second down. Still he wants to throw. Fires it incomplete. He had Andrew McGrath wide open, who had split the seam of the secondary, but he overthrows him incomplete, and it brings up third down 11.
Well, Joe Crowson talked about that play right there earlier today, and he said you just got to hope they don't complete it, or if they do, you run them down. But if you don't commit everybody to the run, they'll kill you. So you just have to take a chance, hope somebody can run them down, and they miss. That time they miss, but it's open with the Cougars crowding the line of scrimmage like they are.
Third down 11, full house backfield again. Cooper leading 14-7, 7:15 to go third quarter. Stilley runs the option left, and he is hit. Nathan Fort again. Hello.
Nathan Fort just, I don't know where he came from, but he came quickly and losing yardage on third and long, and just there, you don't see him pitch much. That would have been the perfect opportunity for the pitch, but Nathan Fort wouldn't let him.
Nice opportunity for the pitch until Nathan Ford decides to land tonight's slobber knocker of the night. And back in punt formation is Seth Hansen. Dominique Rose goes back deep along with Robbie Johnson. Hansen standing at his own 32, hits it at the 35. Nice punt from the left-footed kicker. Dominique fields it at the 16, and he is down. Right there on the play, the tackle is made by Brandon Daly. And the Cougars have it first and 10. 40-yard punt from Hansen. And Cooper has it first and 10. 6.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Cooper leading 14-7, and what a big drive this one is about to be for the Cougars as they have a chance to go up by 2 touchdowns.
In a lot of ways, this game is looking a lot like last week as Cooper comes out in the second half and scores. And then at this point in the game, they put together a long, time-consuming drive. And if they can do it against this Lake Highlands team that doesn't throw the ball, it's even bigger.
First and 10, Anderson, a pump fake, looks long. Throws long, has a man out there, and it's incomplete. Jesse Sharp looking for the flag at the 45. Good coverage on the play by Anthony Harden. No flags on the play. It brings up second and 10.
A lot of jockeying downfield. The referee's seeing it as incidental, and so no flag. But Sharp, that ball was well thrown by Michael Anderson. He put it right on the money, very close to a big play on first down.
Second and 10, Dominique Rhodes back in the ballgame. Robbie Johnson had checked in for one play, and now Dominique is back standing at the 10-yard line. Anderson will check the playoff on second down. Quick swing pass for Mark Rao, and he's hit at the 17. And down on contact, tackle is made by Justin Penny, the weak side end. And that play netting only a couple, and it's going to bring up third and long for the Cougars.
So the Cougars don't want to give it up here and give up the field position advantage they've had throughout most of this ball game. But that time, that play's been so successful. They fake the little pitch out to Dominique and come back. That time, Lake Island's all over.
Third down and 10. Anderson dropping back, deep drop, swing underneath for Chad Foreman. 15-20. Foreman to the 25, dives for the 30 and has the first down. Got a good block from Everett Frazier at the 25, and Chad Foreman has the first down for the Cougars as the sticks will move.
As we've seen time after time, you get those big offensive linemen out in front of you downfield. Not very many times are they being stopped short of the first down. The linemen really like to get out in the open field and do some blocking. That's what's worked for the Cougars so much, is trying to slow down that rush the way that Lake Highlands defense is concentrating on Rhodes, and they're picking them apart on that play.
First and 10. Here's the handoff to Dominique. Swings it to the right side. 35-40. And Dominique gets about 10 yards on the carry and is very close to another first down.
And that's good to see. That's the longest run of this ball game by Dominique Rose, who's been just a big play. We talked about it before the game. Every 10 times he touches the ball, he scores a touchdown. That 11-yard run right there, his longest carry of this game.
First and 10 from the 41-yard line. 5:14 to go third quarter. Cooper trying to grind it out. The winner will play for a state championship next week. Jesse Sharp comes wide to the left side. Scott Copeland into the slot left. And up to the top is Mark Rao. Here's the pass to Rao. It's incomplete. Boy, very close right there. But the pass was in front of Anderson. Incomplete. It'll bring up second and 10. I heard you saying get on that.
Well, I thought you never know if the referee sees it the way you did, but they've been throwing those quick outs. You don't know if it goes backwards or forwards. One time it went backwards, and it cost the Cougars 9 or 10 yards. That time it goes forward, luckily, on the drop, a little high on that play, second and 10.
Second down, 10, line of scrimmage, the 41-yard line. Anderson sends trips to the bottom of the screen on second down. Here comes the reverse for Corey Aldridge, 45-yard line. Aldridge still on his feet to about the 48. Justin Penny in on the stop along with Travis McElroy, and he'll bring up third down.
We're still seeing a lot of plays that you don't see very often from this Cooper offense. If they're going to have to go down onto the second and third play page of their playbook because of the job Lake Highlands is doing on Rhodes, their number one option, and that time Aldridge on the reverse picks up good yardage, third and short.
Third down and a short three for the Cougars from their own 48-yard line. Michael Anderson from the right hash mark takes the snap, hands it off to Dominique. Dominique bolts his way straight ahead, and he has the first down.
Dominique's still running hard, and that's what he can do for you. He's not only a big play type of guy, he can really lower his head and run over people and get you tough yards inside. First down, Cooper.
Dominique has got to be close to equaling his first half output here in the first 8 minutes of the second half. 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Sharp goes to the right. Rao and Copeland come left. On first down, Anderson, play action fake. Now then in trouble. Anderson escapes one, looks downfield, throws. Has a man, pass caught by Jesse Sharp at the 32. Michael Anderson gets out of trouble. Has that whole shoulder pad thing hanging out. Looks like Elway. And it's another first down.
Big play by your senior quarterback that time. As he looks like he was dead back at the 40, and he just uses his strength to get away, and then has the boys to look downfield, pick out a receiver. Jesse Sharp doing a nice job of coming back and helping the quarterback. 16 yards on a play that looked like a minus 20.
First and 10 from the 32-yard line. Sharp will go wide right side, the line of scrimmage, the left half. Rao and Copeland to the near side on first down. Anderson, shovel pass for Corey Aldridge to the 30. Aldridge manning his way down to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. Gain of four, maybe five. It'll bring up second down. And like you said, Cooper is deep in the playbook trying to open up this Lake Highlands defense.
That time the shovel pass, which I can't remember seeing to a tight end of this season from the Cougars, and it worked for about 4 yards. Nice safe pass because if somebody knocked it down in the traffic there, it's just an incomplete pass. Second down and 6.
From the 29-yard line, 2:45 to go, third quarter. Anderson, three-step drop, fires to the sideline, has a man, Rao. Rao puts his head down, gets to the 20-yard line, and he has another first down. Mark Rao going against two men, going against Rashawn Taylor and Travis McElroy. Simply put his head down, wanted the 20-yard line more than they wanted to stop him, and picks up the first.
Michael Anderson is having. Cooper has gone largely to the run in the second half, has really gotten into a rhythm, and that's good news for the Cooper offense.
First and 10 from the 20-yard line, 2.5 to go in the third quarter. 10th play of the drive for the Cougars. Sharp to the left. Inside handoff to Dominique, and he is dragged down behind the line of scrimmage. The tackle is made by Patrick Hendricks. And it will bring up second and about 12. Castillejas actually in on the tackle for Lake Highlands. Cooper trying to make only their second ever trip to a state final. The first happened in 1967, and the Cougars lost to Austin Reagan on that game where they needed, as they said, one more inch. Maybe we can talk about that more later on. Second down, 13 for the Cougars. A minute 44 to go now. Anderson drops back a pump fake. Looks for the sideline. Has a man. Pass is caught. Great move. Inside, Jesse Sharp. Dive. Touchdown. Jesse Sharp from 23 yards. Just left. Travis McElroy eating some dust.
Oh, man. What a
executed play that was, is Michael Anderson with a strong throw clear across the field. That long out is tough to throw. He put it right on the money, and then Sharp is with an outstanding move to lose his man and get in the end zone. Big play, Cooper. They do what we said they needed to do. They take off 4 minutes off this clock, use up 11 plays, and march down. They're up two scores.
Courtney Martin for the point after the kick is up, and it's good. 1 minute, 36 seconds to go, third quarter. Cooper leads it 21-7 here on cable, Channel 7. Cooper goes 11 plays, 83 yards in 4 minutes and 57 seconds. Jesse Sharp, a 23-yard touchdown pass from Michael Anderson. Courtney Martin has added the point after, 21-7 our score. And in the second half, in the third quarter alone, still with a minute 36 to go in the quarter, Cooper has had the football, Phil Ashby, for 7 minutes and 55 seconds.
And they have really clicked. You have taken Dominique Rose almost out of the game on the rushing side, and Michael Anderson has just taken over. He had 9 completions here in the third quarter and has just been on the mark. His receivers are also running really well after they catch the pass. We've seen Rao and Sharp and Rodriguez all come up with big plays after the catch.
Lake Highlands is getting a big dose of West Texas football right now. Just grind it out, pound it in your face. Slobber knocking football. There's the kickoff. And it will come down to the 12-yard line. It comes down to Harden across the 20-25. Harden comes outside, gets to the 40 and the 45-yard line before he is knocked out of bounds. Michael Anderson in the second half, to give you a couple of numbers. Michael Anderson is 9 of 11 for 102 yards and 2 touchdowns, as this has become Michael Anderson's ballgame.
Well, obviously, Lake Highlands came out to stop Dominique Rose. We've heard a lot of defenses say that's their scheme and haven't been able to do it. To give the credit to Lake Highlands, they've done it, but Michael Anderson and his Cooper coaching staff had an answer so far as they put up 14 points here in the third quarter.
First and 10 for the Cougars from the 44-yard line. Still, he hands it off. First man through, Needham. And Needham is stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Everybody in on this one. Charlie Andrade, the first man there, getting up off the bottom of the pile again is Kevin Stevenson. Second down and 9 for Lake Highlands as we wind it down towards a minute to go in the third quarter. Cooper leads by 14 points. And Sean Stille comes back to the line of scrimmage. We still have not seen DeVarin Hightower in the second half. Stille runs the option left, and he pays the price from Eric Gobert at the 45.
Eric Gobert just one-on-one against the quarterback. His responsibility is to follow him there, and he just does a great job and explodes on the tackle, and he doesn't get back to the line of scrimmage.
Third down and 9 at the 35-yard line of Cooper, the man that is orchestrating this defensive stand, Joe Krausen. Third down and 8 from the 46-yard line of Lake Highland. Still, he wants to pass. Looks long, throws long, and this one is over everybody's head. Closest man to it, Andrew McGrath. And it's incomplete, and it brings up fourth down.
We talked earlier about how the Cooper defense had been on the field so much in the first half, and you worried about wearing them down. That's 2 series where Lake Highlands has only picked up 1 first down. That one's a 3 and out. Now you got to say the same thing about their defense. They've been on the field the entire third quarter.
Dominique Rhodes and Robbie Johnson back deep to accept the punt of Seth Hansen. Hansen standing at the 30-yard line. Snap a little high. The Cooper rush comes in. Hansen gets it away. Dominique fields it on the run at the 20-yard line. Gets to the 25 and the 27-yard line before he is brought down. And 34-yard punt. And Dominique Rose has had a man in his hip pocket all night long. But it's Michael Anderson's night with 3 seconds to go in the third quarter. Cooper has the football first and 10 at their own 27. Time for 1 play remaining in the third. And then you will hear pandemonium from half of Texas Stadium, the crowd that is here.
The Cougars have the football. Third possession of the
3 seconds to go in the quarter. Earlier we found out that when they stopped the play to talk to the band, the Cooper band has been banned. The band has been banned from playing between plays. Anderson hands it off to Dominique. Last play of the quarter. Dominique 30, 35, 40. Swings it outside to midfield. And Dominique Rhodes has a first down in midfield. And we will go to the fourth quarter with Cooper up by 2 touchdowns. We have played 3 quarters here at Shotwell Stadium. And Lake Highlands wants to circle up on the far side of the field because they are getting a dose of West Texas football here at Texas Stadium. 12 minutes to go. Cooper leads at 21-7 here on AISD Cable Channel 7.
More smoke coming from that toaster.
Oh my. Thanks for warning us, Seymour.
I hate smoke. So whenever I see it, I make this noise to warn you. Because where there's smoke, there may be fire.
Be cool about fire, sister.
Be cool.
We go to the fourth quarter here at Texas Stadium in Irving, and they have just announced tonight's official paid attendance. Tonight's paid attendance, 10,865. To see Cooper and Lake Highlands, they have seen a good football game thus far. And Cooper has a 21-7 lead going into the fourth quarter.
Dominique Rhodes, 23 yards on that carry. His longest run by far. He had 38 yards in the game on the ground coming into that play. And you just can't keep him bottled up. I don't think you can for 4 quarters. He's going to get a few of those. And Cooper's offensive rhythm is just on cue right now. They are playing so well. That offensive line may be taking over right now.
First and down, first and 10 for the Cougars at midfield. First play, fourth quarter, Michael Anderson is under center. Checking off at the line of scrimmage, and we start the fourth. Here comes Dominique. Dominique to the 45, leans forward to the 43 of Lake Highlands, a gain of 7. And it will bring up second and 3, and I think the Cooper offensive line that averages 260 pounds is starting to wear down this defensive line of Lake Highlands that weighs 207.
And just remember, all the penetration Lake Highlands got early to get Dominique before it could get going is not happening right now. He's not meeting resistance until he's a couple of yards downfield, and that means that offensive line is really beating them to the punch.
Second down and 4 from the 44-yard line. Twins to the top of the screen. Corey Rodriguez is into the slot. Mark Rao, the wide man out. Jesse Sharp comes right. Here comes Dominique again. Drags a man with him across the 40. And there's a late flag on the play. It may be a hold against the interior line of Cooper. And the penalty is indeed a hold against Cooper. So Lake Highlands will accept this and move Cooper back. Now then, if our Cable Channel 7 crew can get us the shot of this. I lost him across the way. I saw DeVarin Hightower. You can see him now walking at about the 40-yard line. And you've got to start wondering, is it going to be imperative for Hightower to come back into this game for Lake Highlands to have any chance at all to win?
Well, they certainly haven't been the same offensively with him out of the ball game, but you'd expect that. A guy's rushed for over 2,000 yards. But give a credit also to the Cooper defense. They've taken advantage of that situation and just pounced.
Second down, 14 for the Cougars. 11 minutes separates Cooper from the state title game. A little flare is dropped by Jesse Sharp. Jade Gelder, the left tackle, almost had an interception because Sharp actually popped the ball up into the air with his hand. Second down, third down now for the Cougars in 14.
Third down, 14 now from the Cougars.
Cooper trying to deliver maybe a knockout punch to Lake Highlands if they could score on this drive. They have been impressive in the second half. Rao goes wide left. Sharp comes wide to the right. Double tight end formation for the Cougars on third down. Here comes the blitz. Draw play to dominate. Gets to midfield and gets down to about the 48-yard line. The blitzing linebacker really kind of messed the play up for Cooper on that on the play, simply because he came into the gap that they were trying to run the draw into.
Well, he had the right call on the blitz with the draw, but that time, unfortunately, Dominique couldn't get past the first or second wave and break that one. But Lake Highlands going all out on that third down to stop it.
Cooper back in punt formation now. Mark Rao standing at his 38-yard line. Brandon Stover, the deep snapper. Here comes the rush. This one is blocked. Ball is picked up at the 35-yard line. Anthony Harden picks it up, and he's finally run out of bounds at the 10, but Harden is on the ground at the 38. He blocked the punt and fell on it at the 38-yard line. Then he got up with the ball underneath him. He is down at that point. But Lake Highlands has a blocked punt, and they are right back in this one. Up, Cooper up by 14 and 21-7 with 9:58 to go, but Lake Highlands comes back with a football in Cooper territory.
Both teams evidently felt they could block punts tonight, as both have really sent it, and that time Lake Highlands gets it. They had to have something go their way to turn this around. Let's see if this is it.
First and 10, Sean Stilley in at quarterback still for Lake Highlands. From the wishbone on first down, Stilley runs the option. He almost lost the football, and he is down at the 42. Charlie Andrade in on the stop. Good initial pressure for the Cougars, and then Andrade had Stilley when he tried to reverse his field.
Well, Corey Aldridge first stops Stilley from going the way the play's designed, and then Andrade makes sure he's not going anywhere, as they're losing yardage almost every time Stilley keeps the ball.
Second down, 12. Line of scrimmage, the 41-yard line of Cooper. Following the block punt, Justin Smith comes out wide left on second down. Stilley hands it off again for Needham, and Needham is down to the Cooper 35-yard line. Gain of 6 on the play, and it'll bring up third down and 6. And, Phil, you've got the numbers on Sam Needham now.
Well, Needham up to 58 yards on 14 carries, but the Cougars doing an excellent job. This defense has just played outstanding football throughout this game. No big plays. They've really kept this offense under wraps.
Sean Stilley comes to the line, third down, a long 6. Stilley keeps himself inside the 30, inside the 25 and the 20. Stilley's going to go all the way. Touchdown, Lake Highlands. Sean Stilley will score from 35 yards out. And we have ourselves a ball game with 8:42 to go.
Well, that's the one thing the Cougars couldn't do in this situation, and miss a tackle. But you saw Stilley run through one about midway through the secondary, and then there's no one else back there. And something that the Lake Highlands offense had to do is score quickly after the block punt, and they do exactly that as Stilley breaks through. And finally, Lake Highlands has busted a long one against this Cooper defense.
Seth Hansen for the point after out of the hold of Stilley. Snap is good. The kick is up, and it's good. 8 minutes, 42 seconds to go in this ball game. And the far side of the field with some momentum. Lake Highlands crawls back into this one, but Cooper still leads it 21-14 here on AISE Cable Channel 7.
Here's a not-so-fun fact, Vince.
And what is that, your Larry-ness?
A rollover happens every 10 minutes.
Well, how long have we been driving?
9 minutes and 58.
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Buckle your safety belt.
Oh, this job is wearing very thin.
to be an organ and tissue donor, even if you've signed something, you must tell your family now so they can carry out your decision later. Call 1-800-355-SHARE for your free brochure.
The Division II semifinal game, if you haven't thought it was interesting till now, wake up, because this ball game is interesting. 21-14, Cooper leading Lake Highlands. The Wildcats go three plays, 39 yards in a minute, 16 seconds, just what the doctor ordered for the Wildcats. Because, Phil, they were able to score quickly out of an offense that usually is not conducive to quick striking.
You're right, Jimmy, and so far, Stille had not done anything since coming in at quarterback. 9 carries for 8 yards, and then he bucked one for 35 on a missed tackle about 10 yards downfield, and that's the wishbone. You can bottle them up, you can stop them, you can slow them down, but if they bust that one, it's really a backbreaker. Now the Cougars need to put together a nice drive, take some time off this clock with the running attack that really hasn't been very effective tonight at all.
Dominique Rhodes is back deep for Cooper, along with Robbie Johnson to Dominique's left and Richard Rodriguez to his right. And Seth Hansen gets set to kick it off. And Hansen's kick down on the ground, picked up the 25-yard line by Corey Aldridge to the 30, 35. Aldridge to the 40 and out to the 43-yard line. So a nice return by Corey Aldridge to give Cooper good field position with 8 minutes and 34 seconds remaining.
I think if Cooper ever decides to go to the two-back offense, Corey Aldridge is trying for an audition, as he has really turned into quite a runner since he's been able to get so many tight end screens and chances to run kickoff back. He's effective there. The Cougars are start out in good shape at the 43.
First and 10 for Cooper, their own 43-yard line, 8 minutes, 34 seconds to go, and it is now crunch time. Michael Anderson comes to the line of scrimmage, sends Twins to the top of the screen, sends Jesse Sharp down to the bottom. On first down, here comes Dominique to the 45, leaning forward, and slides his way to about the 48, maybe the 49-yard line. Good gain on first down for Dominique Rhodes, and down below us, we see that Cooper defensive unit sitting down. They have been on the field for a long time tonight. And their job is going to be to hold Lake Highlands for 8 more minutes.
You'll remember, Jimmy, we thought Cooper was starting to take over on the offensive line, and really the only thing that hurt that drive last time was the holding penalty. If they can avoid a mistake like that, it still might be true that Cooper's offensive line is winning it down there.
Second down, 4 for the Cougars. Anderson under center, 3 men to the bottom. On second down, here comes Dominique again. Dominique breaks one tackle, gets to midfield into the 49-yard line. Nice play by Dominique to get out of the tackle of Kip Collins, the defensive end, who had him back at about the 45. So he averts about a 5-yard loss, turns it into a 1-yard gain, and it's going to bring up third down on long 3.
This might be the biggest play of this ball game so far, as Cooper can pick up a first down. What a lift as the clock runs with about 7:20 left in this ball game. If they have to give it up, puts a lot of pressure on that defense. It's just been off the field for a few minutes.
Maybe one of the biggest plays of the game, like you said, Phil. Third down and 2. Line of scrimmage, the 49. Anderson gives it off to Dominique. He's tripped up, and I don't think he has the first down. Rhodes is met just off of the left tackle, the right tackle, rather. And on the stop, number 93, Jerome Brothers. And Cooper is going to face fourth down and decision time. They're going to bring the chains across, but I think he is a good yard shy of the first down.
Yes, and it might be a situation where Randy Allen just wants to see how far, as it's clearly short from our vantage point, but Randy Allen really wants to see, and he has the right to see if it's within a yard or so of how close they have to go and think about this. And I'm glad I'm not having to make this decision. You really don't want to give it up. You have a lot of confidence in your offensive line, but if you don't make it in this situation, you really shorten the field with about less than 7 minutes to go. Tough decision.
Well, and the other thing for Randy Allen, what I was going to say, is the cap of the field makes it very difficult to see the yard marker. Cooper is about a yard shy of the first down. And now then, Randy Allen has one of the biggest decisions of his coaching career to make. Fourth down and about a yard. His team leads by 7 points. And this becomes a big decision. It doesn't become that big because here comes the punting unit. And the reason it becomes kind of a scary decision is because the last punt was blocked.
You're right, and Cooper's got to do a job of protecting Mark Rowe, who's done a nice job of getting height under his punts tonight. They could really pin him back here, but they've got to protect him and let him get off the punt. As you see, they set up the wall in front of him here.
Fourth down and less than a yard. Mark Rowe, the punter. 9 men at the line of scrimmage for Lake Highlands. Rao gets the punt away, towers one. This is going to bounce in the end zone. And Mark Rao just now unloads a 48-yard punt. And Richardson Lake Highlands will have the football first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. 6 minutes, 34 seconds remaining in regulation. Cooper leads 21-14.
6:34, 80 yards in front of it. The Cougars last time give up the big play, but so far they have avoided that. That's really the longest run they've given up, and now the crowd gets behind them on this side of the field.
Sean Stilley, still a quarterback. Varn Hightower was injured at the end of the first half. The handoff is to Needham, and Needham gets out to about the 24-yard line before he is dragged down on the play. Gain of about 5 is going to bring up 2nd and 5. Class 5A Division II state semifinal game between the Cooper Cougars and the Lake Highland Wildcats. It has been a good one. 2nd down 5. We wind it down towards 6 minutes to go. Stilley under center, trips in the backfield with it, keeps it, dives across the 25, maybe has the 27, is going to bring up 3rd down and a long 3 for Lake Highland.
Stilley showing a little more confident after that touchdown, looks a little more decisive in when to turn up the field, and that's so key. That's such a key on the option, and a big 3rd down here for the Cougar defense.
3rd down and 2 from the 28 of Lake Highlands. Sean Stilley sends Justin Smith out wide to the left side on 3rd down, gives it off to Needham. He does not have the 1st down. Kevin Stevenson meets him at the point of attack, and now then, a huge decision for Lake Highlands. Jerry Gayden has to make a call now on what is going to be 4th down in about a yard. And with 5 minutes and 8 seconds to go and your full complement of timeouts, I agree with this decision. You have got to punt it away if you're Lake Highlands.
Well, John Makovic, a couple of weeks ago, again, I guess last week against Nebraska, the only difference is he was leading at that point. If you don't make it here, you're pretty much given the game, but it's you got to be careful, Cooper defense, not to let them try to short snap it and pick up it looks like a few inches, but that's why we're up here, Jimmy, not to make decisions like that.
Jerry Gate may have just now changed his mind. He had 9 seconds on the play clock, and he might well have changed his mind about what to do. It is 4th down and inches. After the measurement, you can see from our vantage point that all the ball has to do is reach the 30-yard line. And right now, because it was a touchback, look at how close the ball is. If we can get an up-close and personal shot of the football from our vantage point, Rob Westman working his camera. And you can see how close Lake Highlands is to a 1st down. And now then the offensive unit comes back on the field. Huge, huge play, bigger than all of us, coming up right here. 4th down in less than a yard. Sean Stilley comes up to the line of scrimmage. The play clock has never been restarted. It still stands at 7. And I think that's what the referee is doing. The Cougars, as you look at the play before it starts, Roy Strahan looks like he is going to go mano a mano with Ben Northington, the center for Lake Highlands. And a handoff goes to Sam Needham, and Needham has the first down across the 30 to about the 32. And Northington got a pretty good block on that and is motioning the first down. And Lake Highlands moves the sticks with 4:41 to go.
Well, I'm not surprised they pick up the first down, but I am a little surprised they decided to go with the handoff. That takes a little longer. I fully expected quarterback sneak, but nevertheless, the first down, and they're still alive.
First and 10, 4:35 to go in regulation. Stilley hands it off again to Needham, and Needham crosses the 35 and gets out to about the 38-yard line. Well, one of the things that you can tell about the wishbone is the fact that it takes the play, or the clock continues to wind. So now then there are 4 minutes and 13 seconds to go in the state semifinal. Cooper leads by 7. Lake Highlands has the football at their own 38-yard line. Full house backfield with Stilley. Both sides of the stadium on their feet. Stilley is met at the line of scrimmage. Roy Strahan jumps on for a ride and pulls him down right at the line of scrimmage, and it brings up third down and 4.
Kevin Stevenson's the first one in the backfield to really disrupt things, and then Strahan's out there with some help from his buddies on the corner, and now it's about a 3rd and 4, and if the Cougars can stop them like they did on the dive the last time, they won't be just a few inches away. They'll be a good 3 yards, but at this point, I think you've got four down decisions every time.
On third down, Stilley wants to pass, fires the pass, caught at the 46-yard line. Andrew McGrath has the catch and the first down, and the sticks will move again. First and 10 at the 46-yard line, and what you said last play is exactly true, because with Lake Highlands, the way that they like to run the football, now then, the clock has run down inside of 3.5 minutes, so every play now for Lake Highlands, every new set of downs becomes four down territory. First down, handoff to Needham, and Needham gets to about the 47-yard line. We will go under 3 minutes now to play in regulation. Again, remember, in the state playoffs for the first time, there we don't have to count penetrations, we don't have to count first downs. It would go to an overtime if Lake Highlands could score a touchdown.
This is just strength against strength. This is rushing defense against this rushing offense. Then the clock run a little faster, we're under 3 minutes.
Second and 9, Stilley wants to throw again. Throws long, he's got a man wide open, pass is caught. To the 5 and in, down to the 1 yard line is Drew Harden. Harden simply beats the secondary, and there's the big catch as Sean Stilley throws it all the way down the field. First and goal, Lake Highlands.
That's the one that really scares you, as you've got everybody committed to stop the run. If they sneak one behind you and they connect, there's just a race to see if he can make it. He almost makes it. He's inside the 1, and now we got a whole different set of circumstances.
First and goal, Lake Highlands. Sean Stilley trying to be the hero. Hands it off to Needham. Needham into the end zone, touchdown. Sam Needham from a yard out, and this is a one-point ball game. Good block right up front. And now then, Lake Highlands brings Seth Hansen in for the point after, looking for the tie. Cooper, of course, looking for a block out of the hold of Sean Stilley. Hansen's kick is up, and it's good. 2:31 to go in regulation, and suddenly we are tied. As much as the third quarter belonged to Cooper, the fourth quarter has belonged to Lake Highlands here on Cable Channel 7. Lake Highlands goes 10 plays, 80 yards in 4 minutes and 3 seconds. Sam Needham, a 1-yard touchdown run. Seth Hansen, the point after, we're tied at 21, but the big play, the catch by the halfback, Drew Harden.
51 yards on that play, and if they just set it up, because they pounded the middle and used the quarterback, and you just start inching closer and closer as a defense, and then they bust one. And you got to give Lake Highlands credit on a play like that. It's a gutsy call, and you go for it, and you got to make the play.
Philly, who's been bottled up running, has hit two big passes. That one, 51-yarder, the biggest. And but Cooper's has 231 with an awfully talented offense to still have a chance to pull this one out.
2 minutes and 31 seconds of time for Heroes. Cooper has not trailed in this football game. They led 7-0. It was tied at 7. Cooper then scored 14 unanswered to go up 21-7 in the third quarter. Lake Highlands has scored 14 unanswered to tie the ball game in the fourth quarter. And this has just been an outstanding high school football game here at Texas Stadium tonight. Seth Hansen to kick it off. Dominic Rhodes, the lone man deep for the Cougars, and Hansen's kick is high and deep. Dominic fields it at the 6-yard line. Dominic to the 10, 15, turns it upfield, is met at the 20-yard line and bent backwards. Tackle is made on the play by Aaron Ball, number 45, and so Cooper has 2 minutes and 24 seconds to go 80 yards. If you wonder about Courtney Martin, their field goal kicker, Bill's got some numbers for you for the season for Martin. You've got to think also that his range has got to be somewhere around the 40-yard mark. So Cooper's going to have to get down to about the 20. So they need to go about 60 yards to get into Courtney Martin's point, to get into Courtney Martin's range. His longest field goal of the year actually has been 35 yards. First and 10, here comes the Cooper offense with 2:24. Three timeouts on the clock. Anderson on first down. Hands it off to Dominic, 25 and out to the 27-yard line. William Gilroy in on the stop. Gain of 7, it brings up 2nd and 3. Dominic simply putting his head down and going straight ahead on that one.
24 carries, 90 yards for Dominic Rhodes, which is really the toughest yards of his career, as they have not come easily, and they're not going to in the last 155 that we've got remaining in this game. He is still running very hard.
2nd down 3, under 2 minutes to go in regulation. Anderson under center. The senior hands it off again to Dominic, leans for it, gets to about the 29, and he is going to be about a yard shy of the first down as the clock continues to run at 1:38. You would think that Cooper would not spend a timeout until they picked up an initial first down on the drive. And now then it brings up 3rd down and a long yard for the Cougars. Clock is down to 18 seconds. Anderson still in the huddle. The clock is down to 1:11. And now then 3rd down and less than a yard for Cooper. Anderson with 7 on the play clock. Will do it himself. Gets across the 30 to the 31. And it's a 1st down for Cooper with 1:02 to go in regulation. 21-21 our score. And now that Cooper really can go to work. They picked up the 1st down that they needed without throwing the ball away and having to give the ball right back to Lake Highlands. We go under 1 minute to play in the fourth quarter. Sharp and Rodriguez come to the bottom of the screen. Mark Rao goes to the top. Game clock down to 45 seconds. And now then we've got movement and a flag. Flags at the 30-yard line. I think we may have movement against the Cougars. It is a legal procedure, and there have not been a lot of penalties in this ball game, Phil.
That's Cooper's 4th penalty for 40 yards, and the clock has just run down to 44 seconds now left in this game. Cooper, I think, afraid of a little bit afraid of turning the ball over down here in their own territory. They want to be very careful. They execute here and do it safely.
Down to 33 seconds on the game clock. Anderson drops back, little swing pass for Dominic, who is met at the 20-yard line, gets to the 22. It's going to bring up 2nd down, and I think you're about to see overtime in a state semifinal game. Cougars show no desire really to call a timeout here. The clock runs down to 10 seconds, and Cooper's not going to run another play, and we are going to go to overtime in the Division II state semifinal game. And for the first time, Phil Ashby, history will be made, because we will see overtime in a state Final Four game. The overtime rule is new this year, and aren't you glad they're about to end it this way instead of looking at penetrations and first down?
Especially the way I've been keeping penetrations over the years. I seem to miss one along the way, but this is what the fans wanted for so long, is to be able to decide it on the field instead of keeping up with penetrations, first downs, total yardage, all that kind of stuff. And now we'll see how it works. For those who are not familiar with the overtime, Jimmy, let's tell them how it's done.
All right, there is a quick break while the captains will come back out onto the field. They will reflip the coin. The winner of the coin toss has the option of whether they want the football first or last. Then you get the ball at the 25-yard line, your opponent's 25. It is simply first and 10 from the 25-yard line. You have four downs to get 10 yards and keep the drive alive, or you can kick your field goal. If a turnover is committed, the opposing team gets the ball at the 25-yard line. The first team that is ahead after both teams have had equal number of chances is declared the winner. The only way that doesn't happen is if one team has the ball, they throw an interception, and the defense returns it for a touchdown, then the game is over.
And they can be exciting, and you just keep going. If you have a tie score after each time, you get keep going until someone scores and the other one doesn't. You really, most coaches like to win the flip and then want the ball after the other team has a chance, because you know what you have to have. If the other team kicks a field goal, then you know you can still kick a field goal for tying it. But if they have a touchdown, you know you've got to have a touchdown. So expect the winner of the coin flip to want the ball second, not first.
They wait to talk to the captains. They take a three-minute break, and that's what they're doing. They're allowing the team just to kind of get their collective breath at the moment. Miles Durham down there for Cooper going to walk out. And the captains will come out. It's Tentsville. To recap the scoring while you watch the coin toss, Cooper opened the scoring with 3:35 to go in the first quarter. Michael Anderson scored on a 5-yard touchdown run, capping off a 3-play, 8-yard drive that took a minute 15 seconds. Courtney Martin had the point after to make it 7-0. In the second quarter, DeVar and Hightower, a 13-yard touchdown run. Seth Hansen had the point after to tie it at 7. In the third quarter, Corey Rodriguez, a 4-yard touchdown pass from Michael Anderson. Martin had the point after to make it 14-7. Then Jesse Sharp, a 23-yard touchdown pass from Anderson. Martin added the point after to make it 21-7. Cooper looked to be in charge. In the fourth quarter, Sean Stilley, a 35-yard touchdown run. Seth Henson, the point after, 21-14. And then with 2:31 to go, Sam Needham, a 1-yard touchdown run. Hansen added the point after, 21-21. And I believe Cooper won the toss and will defend a first. So now then, Cooper will get a look at what Lake Highlands can do. And if Lake Highlands does not score, Cooper knows that it just takes a field goal. If Lake Highlands scores a field goal, Cooper knows that they can tie with a field goal and go to round two, or a touchdown wins the ball game. Third option, if Lake Highlands scores the touchdown, Cooper knows they must score a touchdown. Both teams have played, or no, I checked that, Lake Highlands has played an overtime game. They defeated Mesquite 20-14. That was back in week 7 of the year. Cooper almost went to overtime in the first round of the playoffs. They defeated, however, Amarillo High on Dominique Rose's last rush of the game, 57 yards that Cooper scored on that, as they were able to defeat Amarillo High by that same 20-14 margin. Here we go with overtime. Sean Stilley is still the quarterback of Lake Highlands. On first down, fumble, and the Cougars are on it. Right in the middle of the mess is Roy Strahan, and he knocks the ball away from Stilley. Oh, my. Cooper has the ball from their 25-yard line.
Big time play. Roy Strahan, as he just beat his man so quickly and bats the ball away from Silly, and he's there to pounce on it. How about a momentum switcher right away?
Roy Strahan goes big on big, hat on hat. He causes the fumble, and Cooper has it now at the 25-yard line. All they need is a field goal to win the ball game and go to the state title game. Mark Rowe will go wide to the right side. Scott Copeland goes into the slot. Jesse Sharp comes wide left. Anderson on first down, hands it off to Dominique to the 20. And Dominique Rhodes has about six to the 19. Boy, the first play of overtime, Roy Strahan comes up big. Second down and four for the Cougars. Anderson sends twins to the bottom of the screen. Jesse Sharp goes wide right. On second down, Dominique tripped up, falls down the 22-yard line. Travis McElroy in on the stop. At the moment, you're looking at a 39-yard field goal attempt as Everett Frazier gets up limping for the Cougars.
That's really what you didn't want in that situation, as Lake Highlands makes a nice play, knifing in and knocking him out, but you had gained five on first down, and then you come back and lose it. You want to do something extremely safe here. You don't want to turn it over because you're in good field goal position. Martin has hit from this area with plenty of distance, so look for something safe, maybe Dominique again.
Third down and seven from the 22-yard line. Michael Anderson wants his timeout. Anderson will take the timeout. We need to check the timeouts because they just now wiped Cooper down from 3-2. But I think both teams just have one timeout in the overtime.
All right, they just changed the board as you said that, and now Cooper without a timeout, so they burn the only one they have. But Michael Anderson left no choice. As they were a little slow getting out of the huddle, he looks up, he's ready to bark out the signals, and there were 2 seconds left on the clock. You don't want a mistake because you're rushing things here. Boy, a lot of pressure on some high school kids right now.
How'd you like to be Courtney Martin right now?
Oh, I don't want any part of that, as we could see him on the sideline kind of being left alone, going through the motions of practicing his kick and everything. He's hit some big field goals this season for the Cougars. Hasn't had much of an opportunity in the playoffs, however.
Third down and seven from the 22-yard line. Cooper will break the huddle. They will send Jesse Sharp and Scott Copeland wide to the right side. Mark Rao comes left on third down. Play clock down to 15. Anderson takes the snap. Wants the pass. Has time. Drops back. Now they're being pressured, and Anderson is down at the 27. So a sack takes the ball back to the 27-yard line, and now then, that's a coverage sack. And on fourth down, Courtney Martin will come into the ball game. And down there at the 30-yard line, you see Joel Bundick, the former soccer coach at Cooper, now then the JV soccer coach, and the kicking coach for this football team, having a last word for his kicker, Courtney Martin.
Well, Lake Highlands has done a nice job. They had that screen totally covered, and Michael Anderson did the right thing. He did not throw it out there and try to force it. He tried to tuck it in and get it back to the line of scrimmage. But on two plays, after second and five, the Cougars lose 7 yards, and now have turned this into a tough field goal position. You're looking at he snaps it from the 27, about a 44-yarder, the way I look at it.
The good news is he's on turf.
That's true, Jimmy. A lot of bumps and ridges and grass that you don't get on turf. It's about as smooth as you want. And he gets the tee, so he's got to feel comfortable kicking in this place. No wind is in a stadium like this that's surrounded just with a hole in the roof. It's just a lot of pressure on a kid who hasn't kicked a lot of field goals. He has 5 for the season. The last time he missed was in Amarillo High with the real strong wind to his back. He missed wide a couple of times, but he has the leg to reach it from this distance.
Kevin Hoffman will snap. Scott Copeland is the holder. It will be spotted at the 34-yard line. A 44-yard attempt for Courtney Martin. The snap is high. Martin's kick is on the way, and it is no good. It is wide to the right, but a flag is down. And I believe that they roughed Courtney Martin. And it's the personal foul, 15-yarder. And the Lake Highlands side has gone stone-cold silent.
Oh, what a turnaround as Courtney Martin didn't get a good foot into that one as it kind of just fluttered to the right and didn't get there. But he was on the ground. He couldn't even see the way it happened. They called the 15-yard penalty, and that's an automatic first down for Cooper inside the 15-yard line the way I see it.
It will be interesting now to see if Cooper sends Martin right back onto the field. They'll bring the offense out, and it's a first down for the Cougars. And how big of a play is that? The personal foul, roughing the kicker. And here comes the offense back on the field. The line of scrimmage will be the 14-yard line, 13-yard line for the Cougars. The far side of the stadium got quiet, and now then they try to urge on the Wildcats of Lake Highlands. Meanwhile, Michael Anderson tries to lead his team to the state title game. Here comes Dominique. Over the top, inside the 10 on first down, down to the 8. Second down, and now then the Cougars looking at extra point range field goal.
You really want them to go in and go ahead and punch this one in and not put it on the shoulders of one player like you have to do on a field goal. That offensive line has just got to gut up and get them inside. A nice first down play. They picked up 6 yards on first down. That's a key in this.
Second and 5. Here comes Dominique again, and Dominique is down at the 9-yard line, a loss of a couple on the play. It brings up third down for the Cougars. It's going to bring up third and about 6 from the 9-yard line. Cooper needs the 3 for a first down. And now that I think that you keep something inside the hashes, I think again you're going to see Dominique Rhodes carry the football.
You can take a shot with an incomplete pass. If it comes back there, you got to go in the end zone. You got to be careful.
Third down, 6. Anderson under center. Takes the snap. Here comes Dominique. Dominique banks his way down close to the 5-yard line. Is not a first down, and Courtney Martin comes out again. We will pretty much let the crowd tell the story on this one. As Courtney Martin comes in, and this time they will spot the ball at the 12-yard line. It is a 22-yard attempt for Courtney Martin. Again, out of the hold of Scott Copeland. The deep snapper here is Kevin Hoffman. Snap is good. The kick is up.
The penalty on the first miss. The kid gets to come out here, Courtney Martin, and get a second chance. I don't care if it's 22 yards or 5 yards. That field goal's tough to make in that situation. I don't see how he's still enough. I was shaking up here. How does a kid that's about 16, 17 years old handle the pressure like that? You got to give him credit. Two excellent football teams. That was a war, and Cooper will move on.
And Lake Highlands is stunned. One of the top teams to come out of the Metroplex. They were 13-1 coming in. They will leave 13-2 on the season. And for the second year in a row, Richardson Lake Highlands has lost in the state semifinal game, and the Cooper Cougars, like we said, in 1967 went to the state title game. They were an inch away. Next week, next Saturday, the Cougars try for one more inch.
One more inch, and we'll hear that a few times, I think, this week in preparation for that game. But give Randy Allen, congratulations, Randy Allen, his coaching staff, this team. They have exceeded all expectations this year. Ever brought us. This team was 3-3 back in October, and now they're playing for the state championship. Some people believe the best football playing state in the country, and I don't know what else to say, Jimmy. I'm just looking forward to going to see it.
I think the pictures tell all the words right now as we look down on the field and we see a very happy Cooper Cougars team and the fans that have not gone away yet.
Roy Strahan right here on Cable Channel 7. Roy, first play of overtime, you get a head on the football, look like from upstairs, and you're able to knock it away. Describe the play.
Like, we only have four plays to go. I had to go all out. As soon as he hiked the ball, I went straight after the running back, and he didn't exchange it yet, and I hit the ball, and the ball was on the ground. I picked it up.
You guys did a great job all game long of stopping the wishbone. Derwin Hightower goes out of the ball game just before the half. You guys win the locker room, and knowing that Hightower was out, how did that change your defensive alignment in the second half?
Well, it really stayed the same. We just went after who we had to go after. That's pretty much it.
One more inch from 1967 to 1996. It's next week. How do you feel about the state title game?
I feel great. I feel go Disneyland.
Roy Strahan, congratulations.
Thanks,
Michael Anderson sits here 155 yards in the air in the second half. What'd you guys do in the second half to open it up?
We talked at half, and you know, we weren't gonna change anything. We were just gonna stick to our game plan and get the running game going and mix in those screens like we've been doing. And you know, they were working. We got some big plays right there the first of the second half, and you know, we got the two scores, and you know, they came back and tie the game, and goes to overtime. I can't believe it. I mean, they had all the momentum going into overtime.
You know the tradition and the history as well as anybody. 1967, an inch short. This year, maybe it's redemption time. What do you do for one more inch?
Well, we just got to keep doing what we've been doing all season long. You know, this is awesome. Everybody's so excited. It hadn't happened in 30 years, and you know, we're gonna get that inch. We're gonna get it. We're gonna go back to work on Monday, and we're gonna practice hard all week, and come next weekend. You know, we're gonna get that inch.
Congratulations. Joe Krausen, you were on the staff of Emory Ballard at Mississippi State. The guy is credited for inventing the wishbone. No better time to come up with you being at Cooper High School than tonight, when the state semifinal game, you get to play a team that no one has stopped out of the wishbone.
Well, that's true. Of course, you know, they didn't do anything that was a whole lot different than other people do. You know, they run a real good option play, though, which is, you know, a midline option, which is different than the regular wishbone a little bit. And that's what posed a little problem for us, because we had never seen it and had worked against it. So it was a little different for us. And consequently, our kids made some adjustments, and they took care of the big fullback up inside and did a great job, you know, taking him all night long.
What was the difference in quarterbacking when Hightower goes out of the ball game and you see Stilley for the entire second half?
Well, I felt like, you know, he wasn't quite as quick. I felt like we'd put more pressure on him, which we did. We came after him more than we did the other quarterback. But, you know, he was still big and strong when he broke that touchdown back on us. You know, we had people that hit him, and he cut back underneath us and made a good run. You know, we had people in position to make the play, and we just didn't make it, you know. And he's a good quarterback. You know, he's played a lot this year.
This is starting to get fun.
It is fun. You know, you enjoy this. It's the furthest I've ever been in the playoffs. I was in the semifinals back in 1966 when Coach Ballard was coaching at San Angelo, and he beat us that year, and he won the state championship. So it's been a nice reward. It really has.
You guys got to overtime, and Lake Highlands had the football first, and you tell your defense to go out there, put a head on the football, and recover a fumble?
Well, we pressured the ball real, real hard. I'll say this. We put a lot of pressure up in the A-gap that time, and which we had been doing a lot on first down, and we penetrated real hard, and the kids made some plays. You know, they made a play, and we've been telling them all night long, or we had all week long, that if they kept raking the ball and hitting the ball, they'd create some fumbles. And I don't know, I mean, we recovered, I don't know what, 3 fumbles tonight? So, you know, we felt like that would happen. That happens when you run a wishbone. It's a high-risk offense because the ball's out here moving around, the quarterback's kicking it around, pitched it, and consequently, you're going to have some fumbles, and you're going to lose some of them.
I'm so proud of the way they play tonight. This semifinal championship was the Permian victory was sweet, but this was much sweeter. And these guys continue to amaze me how hard they play and how much they've improved from the beginning of the year to right now.
A lot of credit has to go to your defensive coordinator, Joe Krause, because no one had stopped that wishbone of Lake Highlands. I know you told me earlier in the week you guys have been breaking film since you knew who you were playing. And what a great defensive game plan today.
Well, no bigger play than the first play of overtime getting that fumble recovery. But he had a great plan, and our defensive guys worked so hard, and our players believe in what they're telling them. And for us to get ready in 3 days for a wishbone attack as multiple and as complicated as they are, and to shut them down like we did, that's a tremendous, tremendous job.
Congratulations, an outstanding season thus far. One more inch next week.
Well, Jimmy, it's hard to, I mean, I can say it now. It doesn't feel comfortable yet, but it will. We're playing for the state championship next week.
Congratulations again for Randy Allen. That'll do it here on AISD Cable Channel 7. It's a final. Cooper goes to the state final next week, 24-21 against Lake Highlands tonight. For Phil Ashby and for the rest of the crew here on Cable Channel 7, I'm Jimmy Polk. Thank you for watching, everybody, from Texas Stadium. And just remember, everybody, CHS is just one step away. We've had an exciting year covering Cooper on Cable Channel 7. And as the song goes, the secret of tomorrow is to live your dreams today. The Cooper Cougars, remember the magic one more time.
Through an open field.
still inside of you. The secret of tomorrow is to live your dreams today. Remember the night, remember the feeling, remember the magic in our lives. You opened up my eyes.
The magic.